Welcome to the fantasy audiobook. Marvel. Everything around me can mutate, Wanda has mutated too. Chapter 41. Obviously, at the moment, the male assassin struggled extremely. On the one hand, it is the bottom line of being a killer and the issue of family safety. On the other hand, his desire for the extreme dagger in his mind has begun to become crazy. "Do not," the man yelled, almost collapsed. He looked at Lin Yu's outstretched finger, his eyes were bloodshot. "The employer is," the man slowly said. At the moment, when the female assassin lying on the ground heard the man's words, her eyes suddenly widened. Her face suddenly turned pale. "No, don't say it," the female killer yelled frantically. "The two act as partners. If the mission is successful, the two will share the commissions, and the mission will be responsible for the failure. But if the partner sells the employer's information, the fate of the two will be equally miserable." "No, you shut up." The female assassin was still howling. But the male assassin didn't seem to hear it, and he said slowly, "The employer's name is Obadiastan." When the name was spoken, the male assassin seemed to have lost his soul, and suddenly squatted on the ground. In the end, the lucky cat defeated his stubbornness. And at the moment, after hearing the name Obadiastan, Lin Yu didn't seem to be surprised. After Lin Yu crossed this world, he sinned two people altogether. One is General Ross of the military. The other one is Obadiastan. When the two killers started to act, Lin Yu had basically determined who was going to kill him. If it were General Ross, it is estimated that he would not spend money to find a killer. He would definitely arrange for his soldiers to deal with him. So, Lin Yu had already guessed the old fellow Obadiastan. The old guy didn't expect to be so restless, he seems to be looking for death. Lin Yu's mouth curled slightly and said to himself. At this moment, the male assassin who was paralyzed on the ground was finally relieved. He slowly got up and said to Lin Yu, "Now you can sell me this superb dagger, right?" Lin Yu smiled slightly. Then he said to Wanda on the side, "Sister, go collect the money." When Wanda heard this, his face suddenly showed excitement. "How much did my brother say just now? It seems to be $10,000. Oh my goodness, got rich. Sure enough, my brother is the real boss of this black shop. A fruit knife sells for $10,000. Wanda gave Lin Yu a thumbs up, and hurried to the back of the bar. "Take out the POS machine." Swipe. The operation was swift, and the transaction was completed in less than half a minute. At the moment, the male assassin held his beloved fruit knife in his hand, his face showed a smile as he wished. He turned slowly and walked towards the door again. But behind him, Lin Yu suddenly squatted down at this moment, touched Erha's head lightly, and said to Erha, "Silly dog, I haven't prepared breakfast for you yet, are you a little hungry?" Lin Yu reached out and pointed at the male killer who was walking outside. Erha instantly understood the master's thoughts. Its eyes suddenly lit up. A touch of green instantly occupies its entire eyeball. Immediately afterwards, its whole body quickly turned into a green appearance. Erha happily ran forward a few steps, chased after him, and came to the back of the male assassin. At the moment, the male assassin was still lowering his head and carefully admiring the fruit knife in his hand, without paying attention. Behind him, a huge green dog's head suddenly approached. Erha's head grew several times in an instant. Then, he opened his blood basin and swallowed the male assassin in one bite. This scene scared the female assassin on the ground. She dragged her broken body with several fractures, and crawled backwards frantically. He shouted in horror, "Don't eat me, I am willing to explain everything, I will be a cow and a horse for you." However, at the moment Lin Yu took out his glasses from his jacket pocket without any haste, wiped them and put them on slowly. Then he looked at the female assassin on the ground and said, "If you just told me earlier, now I don't have anything I want to know." In the eyes of the female killer, the smile on Lin Yu's face was even more terrifying than the devil. Lin Yu with glasses is like a real gentle beast. At this moment, Erha at the door finally swallowed the man's body completely. Its head is big, but its belly is just a little bigger than before. I don't know where the body of an adult of that size has been placed. At this moment, Erha turned his gaze to Lin Yu, as if waiting for his master's order. Lin Yu sighed slightly. It seemed that he took off his glasses with reluctance, and then nodded gently. Such a good figure is indeed a pity. But There are already two women in the family, and if you add one, I guess I'm really going crazy. Let's give it to Erha as a snack. Seeing the master nod, Erha happily ran to the female killer again. Time flies. During this time, Lin Yu once again led a happy and happy life. This time, it was really happy. After the last assassination of the killer, the two women around Lin Yu reached a settlement. Especially after seeing Sharon rescue Lin Yu for the first time, Wanda's attitude towards Sharon was much better. And Sharon gradually understood that Lin Yu was just a brother-sister relationship with Wanda. Wanda was just wishful thinking. So, her views on Wanda have also changed a lot. In the daily contact, I actually had a feeling of treating my sister. Make Wanda feel warmer. This has contributed to a harmonious life in the grocery store. And Lin Yu finally succeeded in living a happy life. It's okay to admire the beauties, go shopping and walk the dog occasionally, so happy and happy. During this time, SHIELD has not been idle. Because the captain of the United States, who was frozen, was still alive. Nick Fury took the Hill agent and went off the court personally to help the captain of the United States adapt to his current life. Natasha Romanoff and Phil Coulson received new assignments. They discovered that Tony was the identity of Iron Man, and seemed to perceive that Obadiestan, the second largest shareholder of Stark Industries, seemed to have a problem. Natasha Romanoff began to protect Tony, and Phil Coulson began to investigate Obadiestan. New York Military District. After the last time the Green Giant Erha brained New York Military Base. The New York Military District has undergone a long period of restoration and maintenance. Finally, the previous combat effectiveness was restored again. The destruction of aircraft and tanks was a minor problem for General Ross. The military is not short of money. And these things, as long as you have money, you can easily buy them. The biggest loss for General Ross in that Erha attack was that the Hulk took advantage of this chaos and escaped. He was furious about this. The hatred for Lin Yu in my heart is almost overwhelming. Although he is not sure that the Husky Erha is Lin Yu's Husky changed. But, as soon as his subordinate Havoc returned from Lin Yu's grocery store, his base was attacked. Moreover, only Havoc and a few of his team members died. This is obvious enough. For General Rose, the only good news is that although the Hulk has escaped, the military has left a lot of Hulk's blood during this time. Combining some research data of Mr. Land's past, the military's research progress is advancing by leaps and bounds. It really made them research something. At the moment, in the underground secret base of the New York military base, General Ross is standing in front of a huge amounts of bulletproof glass, watching the experiment in progress in the laboratory. On the other side of the glass, three soldiers with disabilities are being fixed on the erected iron bed. The three of them either had a broken arm or a leg. And this time the experiment was also used by General Ross to recover physical disabilities and lure them to participate. At this moment, several military researchers in white coats finally made all the preparations. General Rose held a communicator in his hand and said to the people inside, "Let's start when you're ready." Several scientific researchers simultaneously pressed the red button on the machine. Suddenly, several tubes of dark green liquid were injected into the bodies of three disabled soldiers. After the injection started, several scientific researchers hurriedly opened the door of the laboratory and came outside. Even the participants in their experiments were a little scared about the goal of the experiment after the injection of these liquids. Because they have done many human experiments before. Almost all failed. This is their fifth human experiment. And at the moment, outside the glass, General Rose also became slightly nervous. The success or failure of the experiment is extremely important to him. He can't wait, as the dark green liquid was gradually injected into the bodies of the three soldiers. Changes have also appeared in their bodies. First, their eyes began to turn green. Immediately afterwards, the skin of the whole body gradually turns green. Then, their bodies began to skyrocket wildly. The muscles all over his body began to bulge in an extremely exaggerated way. The green veins are exposed. This process seems extremely painful. The three of them couldn't help howling frantically. In the previous experiments, when the muscles began to bulge, the entire body of the subject suddenly exploded and turned into a pool of blood. But today, The muscle uplift speed of these three subjects seems to be significantly slower than the previous few times. General Rose gradually showed a hint of excitement. If it succeeds, it represents its own army and will have a group of terrifying super soldiers. Even stronger than the super soldiers made by Super Serum. After a few minutes, the bodies of the three soldiers in the laboratory finally slowly stopped changing. The body parts of the three soldiers at the defective moment all regrown. And, the scariest thing is their size. Almost all of the three soldiers became monsters over 2 meters long and full of explosive power. Their skin did not turn into bright green like the Hulk. It's just slightly greenish, not very obvious. Their height, although much taller than ordinary people. But, it's still within the range of normal people. It's just a little bit taller than the average basketball player. The only difference from ordinary people is their eyes. The eyes of the three people, whether they were white or black, all turned dark green. It's like a demon from far reaching. Just by looking at each other, you can feel the oppression from the three super warriors. At this moment, the three soldiers, with a light wave of their hands, broke free of the belts holding them. A look of hideousness appeared on the faces of the three of them. This experiment not only gave them terrifying bodies, but also made their minds more irritable. The dark green potion developed by the blood of the Hulk greatly increased their desires. But, the soldiers' instinct still made the three of them stand in front of the glass one after another, and gave General Rose a military salute. At the moment, General Ross finally showed a knowing smile on his face. All efforts were finally not in vain. He turned around and walked towards his office. As he walked, he ordered, "Let the three of them come to my office to see me." After a few minutes, General Ross's office, General Rose sat quietly behind his desk. In the center of the office, stood three super soldiers with extremely majestic figures. He slowly said, "From now on, the three of you will only obey my orders and be directly under my jurisdiction. Now, let me give you the first task to bring back an Asian young man named Lin Yu and his pet dog." A cruel smile appeared on General Rose's face. This hateful guy, if he falls into his own hands, he will definitely make him want to die. At the moment, just when the three super soldiers set out to perform their tasks under the order of General Ross, Lin Yu is doing his favorite activity every day. Walk the dog. Although the home also has beautiful scenery. But, if you see a lot of scenery, you will always feel a little tired. So, every evening, walking the dog is still Lin Yu's happiest moment. At the moment, on the streets of Manhattan where neon lights are flashing and pedestrians are endless. Lin Yu was wearing a well-made beige trench coat, with a pair of slightly gentle gold-framed glasses on his face, and holding Erha's dog leash in his hands, which formed a sharp contrast with the rushing crowd on the street. Yawned lazily, Lin Yu's mentality at the moment is completely different from these mortals. They also need to work hard to make a living every day. But Lin Yu has already left this state, although he still didn't have a few dollars. But, there is no money in the bank card. Well, actually the money in the stock market is also Wanda's. Never mind, I still don't want money anymore. There is a little girl who is greedy for money, Lin Yu really can't save money. Fortunately, Lin Yu himself has nothing to spend. Wanda and Sharon look after the grocery store. Wanda is well served by Wanda every day. Except for the physiological problems, I haven't figured out how to solve them, and all other life problems have been arranged clearly. Even, sometimes when I am really hungry, some food may be contaminated in the microwave in the kitchen. At this moment, several white-collar women who seemed to have just got off work, after seeing Erhan's cute look, suddenly surrounded them with surprise. They look pretty good. According to Lin Yu's aesthetic standards, he can at least score 7 or 8 points. This is pretty good. Lin Yu hurriedly helped his glasses, a simple and shy smile appeared on his face. And Erha, who was surrounded by a few beauties, also began to show off his chubby body vigorously. Its writhing in front of a few beauties caused them to laugh. Lin Yu quietly found a right angle and watched this happy scene with a smile. "Really, you still have to come out to see the scenery. Always stay at home, no matter how beautiful the scenery is, you will get bored." However, at this time, in the beautiful scenery, a few uninvited guests suddenly entered. Three strong men who seemed to be 2 meters, 4 or 5 meters tall suddenly appeared beside Lin Yu and Erha. All three of them wore camouflage uniforms with a black mask on their faces. Although there is no weapon on his body. But, just seeing the terrifying bodies of the three of them seemed to be able to feel an invisible pressure. Although the streets of Manhattan are crowded with people. But, the three soldiers surrounded Lin Yu and others without any scruples. Their terrifying size is the greatest deterrent. When pedestrians saw it, they gave way. The beauties surrounded by them seemed to realize that something was wrong, and fled from the gap between the three soldiers. The soldiers didn't stop me at all. Their goal is not those beautiful women. At the moment, the middle of the three soldiers. There is only Lin Yu who is slightly thin and weak, and Erha who is still shaking. The three soldiers, not only wearing masks, but also wearing sunglasses. But, at the moment, Lin Yu has not taken off his see-through glasses. So, I clearly saw the green eyes behind the three people's sunglasses. Lin Yu was shocked in his heart. The identities of these three people are already Roar's desire to come out. Obviously something cultivated by General Ross. Lin Yu remembered that in the Marvel movie, even at the end, General Ross's super soldier plan had never been successful. But, Lin Yu did not expect that this time, he actually made him successful. Perhaps it is because of the changes brought about by one's own journey. But, on Lin Yu's face, I still couldn't see any emotion of fear. Just a few super soldiers. Even if the Hulk, the source of their mutation, stood in front of him, Lin Yu didn't worry at all. His Erhu not only wags his tail to please girls. At this moment, one of the super soldiers opened his mouth and said buzzingly, "Come with us, the general wants to see you." His tone was not a question. It was a tone of command. After all, in his opinion, Lin Yu's thin body can even crush him into meat sauce as long as he stretches out a finger. In front of him, Lin Yu had no room to fight back. Nor does it have the power to decide one's own destiny. "What if I don't want to go?" Lin Yu said lightly. He really didn't want to go. If the system is upgraded to level 4, which can make everyone around him mutate, Lin Yu may be willing to take a trip and teach that General Ross a profound lesson. But, the system now has only 3 levels. Lin Yu will never take personal risks. Hearing Lin Yu's words, the soldier showed a trace of hideousness on his face, and then stretched out his palm with a big laugh. Slowly, squeezed in the air. Suddenly, there was a crackling sound in Lin Yu's ear. "I advise you to follow us honestly, otherwise I won't be able to grasp the strength of my hand." The super soldier said buzzing again. Just when the super soldier threatened Lin Yu just finished. In Lin Yu's mind, the voice of the system rang again. "Ding, your pet dog became angry because he sensed that his owner was threatened, and he took the initiative to integrate the two energies on his body, and evolved into a third-order mutant creature, the three-headed dog of the Green Hell, and possesses the splitting ability." Quote. Hear this familiar voice. Lin Yu felt relieved immediately. Although this infinite mutation system is passively mutated and not under its own control, it never loses the chain at critical moments. "I just don't know what the so-called three-headed dog of the Green Flame Hell looks like. Split ability, what exactly is it? But, since it is a third-order mutation, it must be stronger than the previous second-order mutation. This is for sure." At this moment, Lin Yu's heart is true, and he naturally speaks more openly. "Since you are Ross's subordinates, you should all know Havoc, right?" Lin Yu still heard the name Havoc from Sharon. Since becoming Lin Yu's assistant, Sharon has told him a lot about the internal affairs of the military and SHIELD. Havoc, which was eaten by Erha as a dessert, naturally did not fall. Hearing the name of Havoc, the three super soldiers were obviously taken aback. They naturally knew Havoc, the number one soldier under General Ross. Only, isn't Havoc dead? At this time, Lin Yu pointed to Erha on the ground, and then said, "Havoc, it was eaten by my pet dog, I guess your ending should be similar." Heard this sentence, the three super fighters were taken aback for a moment, and then a hideous expression appeared on their faces. How can they stand such an insult? The three felt that they were so powerful that they could even fight an army alone. The other party actually said that he would be eaten by a small pet dog. How can this be tolerated? The three slowly approached. Especially the super soldier at the front. He directly raised one of his feet, aimed at Erha's head, and prepared to step on Erha on the ground into meatloaf with one foot. Far away, several beauties who hadn't been far out screamed after seeing this scene. That husky is so cute. They can't imagine why anyone would be so cruel. The screams of several beauties immediately aroused the onlookers of the surrounding passers-by. Now, it is in the peak period of off-get-off work. Almost in a few seconds, countless people stopped and watched. And at the moment, just when the super soldier was about to slam Erha's head with one foot, the horrible mutation happened. Erha's body suddenly burned with a raging green flame. The colors of those flames, like ghost fires, looked strange in this evening. The super soldier also suddenly felt abnormal. It's not just the green lights around that caught his attention. Under his feet, there was also a terrifying high temperature suddenly. The high temperature melted the soles of his feet in an instant. Suddenly, there was a fierce burning sensation on the soles of his feet. The super soldier hurriedly retracted his foot. But in just a few seconds, the soles of his feet have all turned into charred black. Had it not been for the dark green liquid they injected to weaken part of their painful nerves, he would definitely be in pain now. And at the moment, the mutation of Erha has just begun. The eyes of the three super soldiers were all attracted by Erha. Even Lin Yu sneaked away without paying attention. At the same time, the green flames burning on Erha gradually attracted the attention of people around him. More and more people were onlookers. Many people raised their mobile phones and started taking pictures. For a while, the lights flickered. But, no matter how many people there are onlookers. Although his master is a low-key person, Erha is not very similar to his master in this regard. The more people there are, the more excited it seems. Even when he mutated, Erha happily shook. The speed of this mutation is very fast. In just a few seconds, Erha, who was burning with green flames, grew up to the height of those super soldiers. Its height and size are still getting bigger. And, at the same time, above the two front legs of its body, two bulges began to bulge. The two bulges quickly enlarged, and then they turned into two equally green dog heads. A few more seconds passed. A huge amount of three-headed dog in the green hell, which was about 2 meters taller than three super soldiers, appeared on the streets of Manhattan. The terrifying temperature began to spread. Compared with the dark red flames before, these green flames have little difference in temperature. But there is a strong corrosion ability. The people onlookers around started to back away frantically. While stepping back, I looked back. The ground under Erha's feet seemed to melt. The three super soldiers who were originally bullish, at the moment also looked very embarrassed. The clothes on their bodies have also begun to turn brown, and they seem to be burning soon. The light green muscles on his body also felt the terrifying temperature and strong tingling sensation. They hurried back, no arrogance in their eyes. Yes, it's just panic. This monster had already made the three people feel the endless fear before they even shot. They hurriedly used the communicator that had not been roasted temporarily to report to General Ross at the headquarters. General, our action has encountered obstacles. One of the target pet dogs has become a monster, very powerful. One of the super soldiers hurriedly reported to General Ross through the military channel. In the communicator, there was the unhurried voice of General Ross. Oh, is it the monster with flames or the green monster? General Rose asked. The monster with flames on his body is the dog who once helped S.H.I.E.L.D. find Tony. A green monster all over, the dog that ruined most of his base. So, which dog is the three of them facing now? General Rose was not worried. Although the tone of the super soldier sounded a little nervous. But, General Ross has obtained the physical data of three super soldiers from researchers. It can be said that General Ross knows their true strength better than themselves. The three super soldiers are not only powerful, but also extremely powerful in defense. The most terrifying thing is that they also have a powerful recovery ability. Combining these kinds of abilities together, whether it is dealing with the burning monster or the green guy, it shouldn't be a problem. At this moment, in the communicator, the report voice of the super soldier came again. R.O., General Ross, is burning with flames. General Ross frowned slightly when he heard the word flame. In fact, that flame monster is a bit more difficult to deal with than the green one. However, he believes that his super soldier will definitely be able to defeat the opponent. 3-1, if you can't win anymore, what is it called a super soldier? R.O., General Ross, it's a burning flame, a green monster. A green monster burning with flames. What it is. General Rose was taken aback for a moment. He had seen a picture of the monster burning with flames, which was clearly dark red. How did it become green? No matter what color it is. No matter what color it is, if you can catch it, bring it back. If you can't catch it alive, just kill it and bring the body back. General Rose commanded coldly. Compared to ordinary people like Lin Yu, he actually wants that pet dog more. If you catch this pet dog back, I believe my super soldier plan will become stronger again. But, at this moment, in the communicator, there was another panicked voice from the super soldier. His voice trembled slightly. General, that monster, turned into three. On Manhattan Street, the asphalt road on the ground has already begun to burn with raging flames. And Erha in the flames, at the moment is like a demon from hell. What's more terrifying is, after it became a full 4 or 5 meters high, the mutation did not stop. But the body began to split from the middle of the three heads. One is divided into three. Three green monsters burning with flames. Each one has grown its own limbs and body. After one was divided into three, the three Erha faced a super soldier at the same time. The original 3-on-1 situation immediately became 3-on-3. But, in front of the three behemoths, the three super soldiers looked very thin. Their original majestic body, in front of the three Erhas, seemed to be three little things. At this moment, in the communicator in the ears of the three super soldiers, General Ross's doubtful voice came again. What three? Isn't there just one monster? How come it has become three again? Tell me quickly. General Ross was obviously anxious. This time, it was the first time that super soldiers dispatched a mission. He has great expectations. Moreover, he also encountered that mutant pet dog. It was originally a thing worth celebrating. However, the performance of the three super soldiers made him a little disappointed. When the three of them reported the battle, they seemed a little silly. The monster that burned flames for a while, then turned green again, and finally turned into three. Hardly, the eyes of the three super soldiers are not so good. Or maybe their bodies have become stronger, but their brains have become stupid. But, after General Rose asked this question, there was no sound in the communicator. After waiting for 2 full minutes, there was no answer. General Rose's face gradually showed a crazy anger. With one hand, he took off the headphones he was wearing on his ears, and suddenly fell to the ground. A bunch of trash, trash, General Ross shouted, at the moment. On the streets of Manhattan. With the three Erha burning green flames slowly approaching the three super soldiers. The clothes on their bodies began to burn. Immediately afterwards. It's all kinds of equipment on them. Even the communicator in their ears turned into a puddle of liquid. The masks on the faces of the three super soldiers naturally did not escape the heat, revealing the three dark faces behind the masks. Their three pairs of eyes were still glowing green. But, at the moment, their eyes were full of panic. After they became super soldiers, the emotions in their hearts were magnified. However, I did not expect that the first emotion to be amplified turned out to be fear. Is it running? Still fighting? As a soldier, to escape without the general's order is to disobey the military order. But, in this situation, let them fight the three terrifying monsters, and they don't have the guts. For a time, the three of them slowly backed away, extremely tangled in their hearts. But, Erha was not entangled. The three Tuha, all of them at the same time, caught up with the three backward super soldiers in an instant. The blood gulp began to bite crazily on the three super soldiers. And the three super soldiers, although they are powerful, faced three monsters stronger than them, that kind of resistance seemed very weak. The recovery of the three people is very strong, but under the endless burning of flames, the recovery speed can't keep up with the scorching speed. The situation of the battle instantly fell to one side. On Manhattan Street, countless pedestrians have retreated hundreds of meters away. Even though it is so far away, I can still feel the scorching temperature in the air. However, there is no life threatening. They took out their mobile phones one after another and took this horrible picture. And at the moment, in the corner of the crowd, Lin Yu was standing behind the crowd, wearing glasses, quietly scanning the people's back. Only, there are a lot of people, there are men and women, which really makes Lin Yu a little depressed. At the moment, suddenly the system reminder sounded in Lin Yu's mind. Ding, your glasses felt the master's inner depression and actively blocked the perceptive function of male creatures. It's all right. Lin Yu was happy in his heart, and his eyes became unscrupulous again. At this moment, the situation of the three-on-three battle has also been thoroughly clear. The three super soldiers are not Erha's opponents at all. 3-2 hectares, easily defeated three super soldiers. And, under the big mouth of Erhana, the three super soldiers all became Erha's rations. The smell of blood permeated all of Manhattan. Among the crowd onlookers, many people even vomited directly on the spot. Although the bodies of the three super soldiers are unbelievably strong. However, they are still human at least. Three living humans were swallowed directly into their stomachs by three huge amounts of green monsters. The blood flowed down the mouths of the three Erhas, dripping constantly on the road, and then was turned into a ball of heat by the scorching temperature. This scene strongly stimulates people's eyeballs. And this time, after swallowing three super soldiers, the 3-2 hectares, and slowly began to stand side by side. Green muscles began to appear on their bodies, like earthworms, entangled with each other. Slowly, the three monsters turned into one again. Until the end, the two heads also slowly retracted into the body and disappeared. Erha's body also began to gradually shrink. Finally, become an ordinary pet dog file-size green puppy. The green puppy seemed to see through the crowd and saw Lin Yu behind the crowd. Lin Yu nodded slowly. The green puppy went into the alley next to it and disappeared. At this moment, the temperature in the air has gradually returned to normal. People began to walk forward two steps tentatively, and only after finding that there were no problems, the crowd began to approach the battlefield just now. When people saw the situation on the battlefield, there was a loud sigh. On the ground, the asphalt on the asphalt road has all been burnt. Only some gravel that was burnt to darkness remained. The three tall and mighty humans have not even been able to stay in this world even a drop of blood. The three-headed dog in the green hell just showed up for less than 2 minutes, and it created such a horrible scene. If you run a lap in the city, it is estimated that the whole city will be messy. Definitely, Lin Yu would not let Erha wander around in the city. If you want to hang out, you should also go to the New York military base. Manhattan Street gradually returned to calm. Although the impact of this incident on the internet is not small. But, people still need to live, and if they don't go out to work, there will be no money to make. Therefore, the mutation of Erhadang Street is limited to fermentation on the internet. In reality, people quickly return to normal lives. Moreover, because Lin Yu escaped earlier, even if the onlookers took a lot of photos, Lin Yu did not have a photogenic. At the moment, in a dark alley on Manhattan Street, Lin Yu squatted on the ground and gently stroked Erha's head. Lin Yu is more and more satisfied with Erha's performance. You can go to battle to kill the enemy, and you can accompany yourself to go shopping and enjoy the scenery. Such a good dog can't be found with a lantern. Unexpectedly, I was met by myself. This is not only the credit of the system, the Erha is definitely not ordinary originally. At this moment, Lin Yu slowly said to Erha, Erha, do you remember the military base last time? It's where there are planes and tanks everywhere. Erha nodded hurriedly. Lin Yu was overjoyed. Just remember. It really is my good dog. It's good for you to become a three-man ability. Help me go to that base and walk around again. When I get there, I can play casually. You can also eat some supper. Hearing Lin Yu's arrangement, Erha's eyes clearly showed a hint of excitement. Indeed, those airplanes and tanks are just toys in its eyes. As for midnight snacks, definitely no one will refuse. Otherwise, how did it grow into this plump look by itself? After Lin Yu explained, Erha stepped on his short legs and trod in the direction of the New York military base. Behind Erha, the corner of Lin Yu's mouth was slightly cocked. Secretly said in his heart, Rose, Rose, let's see how your luck is this time. It is estimated that Erha does not know General Ross. So, Lin Yu didn't explain who Erha specializes in eating, but just let it play at will. Look at your own belly file size decision. This means that the life and death of Ross will be completely determined by Erha. It is indeed quite interesting that the destiny of a general in the military is controlled by a dog. At the moment, General Ross, who was still in the base sulking his subordinates, did not know that a disaster was about to come. But Lin Yu did not pay attention to what would happen to the New York military base. Because, without paying attention, Lin Yu can probably imagine that picture. When the three terrifying Erha appeared there at the same time, it is estimated that the entire New York military base will become a sea of flames. This is Lin Yu's revenge against General Ross. As for whether General Ross would die in Erha's mouth, or be buried in flames, Lin Yu didn't care. Look at Erha's mood. Erha went to a military base in New York. But Lin Yu estimated that Erha would have to run for a long time just on the road. It is estimated that it will be a few hours later to get there. After all, Erha's running speed is really slow when he doesn't change his body. This guy usually eats too well, but he is a bit too fat. And Lin Yu. Then he went back to his own grocery store. As soon as he walked in, Sharon said to Lin Yu, "Boss, I need to get off work for a while, and the director tells me to go back and take care of some things." Normally, Lin Yu sets Sharon's get off work time at 8 p.m. And now, it's only 7 o'clock. Lin Yu was taken aback for a moment, and asked, "What's the matter?" They were all arranged as their own assistants, and they were called back to do other things. Lin Yu was very dissatisfied. Sharon hesitation a bit, still decided to tell Lin Yu. After all, Lin Yu is his own. The director said that they found the captain of the United States who was frozen 70 years ago, but he didn't expect him to be alive. Now, the director wants to arrange for the captain of the United States to meet with my aunt. Oh, yes, my aunt is one of the founders of SHIELD and was also the girlfriend of the captain of the United States. Sharon told Lin Yu everything. Hearing Sharon's words, Lin Yu's eyes lit up slightly. The captain of the United States shows up. And Sharon's aunt Peggy Cat. Putting this together, there are three plot points again. At the moment Lin Yu's plot point, there are already 4 points. If you can get these 3 points again, it will be 7. Lin Yu's heart moved slightly, and then said, "Why don't I go with you? The captain of the United States is my idol, I would love to see him. As an idol, Lin Yu likes to use it the most. No one can stop a crazy fan from meeting his idol." Sharon did not refuse. After all, Lin Yu can be regarded as one of the members of SHIELD. Although only a consultant, he has the right to visit SHIELD headquarters. After explaining to Wanda, Lin Yu drove on his Camaro and took Sharon to SHIELD. For SHIELD, Lin Yu has long been looking forward to it. Definitely, it is not the kind of expectation of ordinary people. But looking forward to gaining more plot points in it. The four-level system is what Lin Yu wants most now. The bright yellow Camaro let out a fierce roar, and swiftly moved towards the SHIELD headquarters. And at the moment, New York military base. But it ushered in another terrible disaster just after the restoration. And, this disaster is more violent than the last time. Last time, it was just a monster. And this time, it was three. And there are three monsters with terrifying green flames burning on their bodies. Three monsters biting everything crazy in the New York military base. The fire was raging, and even the ultra-high-strength metal such as tanks was burnt red. What made the soldiers of the New York military base desperate the most was. This time, the three monsters don't just destroy randomly. They can eat people. If you see someone, you can swallow it in one bite, not picky eaters at all. Crazy. All the soldiers were scared crazy. Even the entrance to the underground base below the New York military base was exposed in the raging flames. A green Erha got in through the narrow hole. Suddenly. Turn upside down. Just walked into Nick Fury's office. Lin Yu and Sharon saw the scene from the TV screen on the wall of Nick Fury's office. At the moment. On the TV screen, the tragedy of the New York military base is being broadcast. A reporter, who was standing a few kilometers away from the New York military base, introduced with a sad expression, "Audience friends, this is the second time a New York military base has been attacked by an unknown creature in a month." Quote, "This time, it was even more tragic than the previous attack. We can see that the blazing flames have completely swallowed the entire base. Even though we are 2 kilometers away from the New York military base, I can vaguely hear the screams coming from there, it's like hell on earth. Our reporter has contacted the Pentagon. It is said that other nearby military bases have dispatched fighter planes to eliminate the monsters that attacked here. God bless, hope justice will always stand by our side. At this moment, Nick Fury seemed to feel Lin Yu and Sharon Hu had arrived behind him. He turned his head abruptly, a one-eyed staring straight at Lin Yu. Frowning, his face is extremely serious. In seriousness, there seemed to be a trace of anger. But Lin Yu didn't care at all, just pulled a chair nearby and sat on it. In addition, Erlang's legs were raised and he looked directly at Nick Fury. At this moment, Nick Fury suddenly said to Sharon, "Sharon, you go out first, I will have a chat with Consultant Lin." But, after hearing Nick Fury's order, Sharon did not leave directly. Instead, he looked at Lin Yu. It seems to be seeking Lin Yu's opinion. Seeing this scene, Nick Fury was taken aback. Then, the frown deepened. "What's the situation? My subordinates, I can't even arrange them." Sharon knew very well that she actually had to listen to Nick Fury's arrangements. But, do not you know why? In her heart, she couldn't help but want to ask Lin Yu for advice. Therefore, she did not go out the first time, but took a look at Lin Yu. At the moment, sitting on the chair, Lin Yu, with Erlang's legs tilted, suddenly said softly, "Sharon, you should go out first." Lin Yu didn't want his assistant to be embarrassed. Hearing Lin Yu's words, Sharon glanced at Nick Fury, her eyes full of apologetics, and then she walked out slowly. Nick Fury's face became more and more ugly. He now felt that he had made a very wrong decision to assign Sharon to Lin Yu as an assistant. But, the most important thing now is not to entangle Sharon's problem. It's something on the TV screen. Nick Fury's face is ugly. It's like eating shit. "Consultant Lin, you did too much, right? I just reported your identity, and you did something like this. How can I explain it to the above?" Nick Fury's face was blue. Black with green. Although the directions of SHIELD and the United States Army are not pleasing to each other, they cannot attack the military bases. After all, both belong to the Great Malekan. Although one is really for the defense of mankind, the other is just a tool for the rich. However, you can't attack the opponent either. Nick Fury feels bitter. He began to reflect on himself, giving Lin Yu the status of a consultant, is it right or wrong? How do you feel that his troublesome ability is much greater than his actual use? At this moment, after Lin Yu heard Nick Fury's words, his face gradually became cold. "You mean, they want to kill me, can't I take revenge?" Lin Yu said slowly. "They are going to kill you." Nick Fury was startled. He really didn't know this matter. "Yeah, you searched the news this evening. Three soldiers were on the streets of Manhattan. They almost frightened me," Lin Yu said without changing his face. Nick Fury actually just returned to his office. "I've been dealing with the captain of the United States before." Therefore, he did not know the previous three superfighters fighting Erha on the streets of Manhattan. After hearing Lin Yu's words, Nick Fury hurriedly searched. Really, the picture that catches the eye is the picture of three super soldiers and three three-headed dogs in the green hell. There are even videos taken by kind citizens. But, how do you feel that this picture is a bit wrong? What I call it scares you. Isn't it that your pet dog frightened those three soldiers? The video showed clearly that after the appearance of the three three-headed dogs of the Green Flame Hell, they easily swallowed the three strong and unprepared soldiers into their stomachs. This is what you said the military wants to kill you. How about you? Nick Fury asked silently. Lin Yu smiled slightly, spread his hands, and said, I am definitely going away, otherwise can I wait for them to kill? But this video shows that your dog has eaten all three soldiers. That's legitimate defense. You haven't been injured, so you won't retaliate against the entire military base, right? If I get injured, it's not just a matter of revenge on a military base. Lin Yu said coldly. Nick Fury has a big head. It sounds like what Lin Yu said makes sense. But after thinking about it, Nick Fury still feels wrong. As the honorary consultant of Avengers, you can't just think of revenge on others. Nick Fury said weakly. I don't bother to pay attention to you, and, this is Erha's own revenge, I can't manage. Lin Yu simply pushed the responsibility directly on Erha's head, loving it. You take your time to study, I'm going to see my idol. Lin Yu got up, turned around and left. Behind him, Nick Fury looked bitter. He has completely regretted it. This Lin Yu, he really can't control. But, there was also a trace of fortune in his heart. Fortunately, it was the stupid General Ross who provoked Lin Yu, not himself. Sharon, go, let's go see my idol. Out of the door of Nick Fury's office, Lin Yu directly recruited Roar, who was waiting at the door. The two went directly to the captain's room of the United States. Nick Fury's worries, let him worry about it. Lin Yu didn't bother to care. Whoever provokes himself must be prepared to be retaliated against. The identity of a little Avengers honorary consultant can't stop oneself. When he first traveled to this world, Lin Yu was very cautious in his work. But now, Lin Yu is no longer the Wuxia Amen of the Year. Ding, congratulations to the host for meeting Marvel's core protagonist, the United States Captain Steve Rogers, for the first time, and rewarding 2 plot points. As soon as he came to the room of the Captain of the United States, Lin Yu had already sounded the system reminder in his mind. Lin Yu smiled and looked at the still confused guy in front of him. He is exactly the same as the image in the movie. It's just that he is still in a daze now. I had just been asleep for 70 years, and only after waking up did I realize that everything had changed. It's really not easy to get over it. Seeing Lin Yu and Sharon coming over, Steve didn't react too much. In the past few days, he has seen many strangers. After a few words with the Captain of the United States, Lin Yu went straight to the subject. Do you want to see Peggy Carter? Lin Yu asked. Steve nodded slowly. He definitely wants to meet. After all, that was the only person he knew in this world. Lin Yu smiled slightly and said, go, I'll accompany you, Peggy Cat is my idol, I also want to take this opportunity to meet. Steve naturally agreed. He was satisfied to see Peggy Carter. I don't care that Lin Yu followed. But, Sharon was a little confused. It seems that my boss said before that the Captain of the United States is his idol. After I met, I didn't get excited. After chatting casually, I'm going to see my aunt. But, just when Lin Yu and Sharon were taking the Captain of the United States, Steve, to go to the hospital to visit Sharon's Aunt Peggy Cart. But in the corridor of SHIELD headquarters, I ran into the Phil Coulson agent. With an anxious look on his face, he was rushing out. Seeing Lin Yu, Sharon and others, he just made a move, Roar. It seems that something urgent has happened. After Phil Coulson walked over, several more SHIELD agents rushed out. Lin Yu frowned slightly and said to Sharon, ask what happened. Hearing Lin Yu's words, Sharon hurriedly grabbed an agent and asked, what happened? The agent glanced at Sharon and seemed to recognize the identity of Sharon's high-level agent. Then, he hurriedly said, there seems to be something wrong with Stark Industries, as if one of its shareholders is called Obadiastan and is doing some dangerous research. After speaking, the agent hurriedly chased Phil Coulson's back. Hearing this explanation, Sharon and Steve didn't feel much. They didn't touch too much about Stark Industries. But, hearing this sentence in Lin Yu's ears, it was different. He knows all the plots of Marvel. In this situation, doesn't it mean? Is Iron Man's first and final plot coming? Tony fights Obadiastan. Lin Yu's eyes gradually lit up. This is the proper main storyline. And it's the finale. This is much more important than seeing a small supporting role like Peggy Carter. And, Peggy Carter won't die for a while, so you can check it out anytime later. However, if things like Tony versus Obadiastan were missed, there would be no chance again. Let's go, Sharon, let's go and see too. Lin Yu hurriedly recruited Roar Sharon, and was about to run outside. Steve behind Lin Yu was anxious. What's going on? Didn't you say it's good to see your girlfriend? Why are you going to Stark? Why does this guy like to join in the fun so much? Then shall we go to the hospital? Steve asked hastily. Lin Yu is in charge of him at this time. Coping said. Go back, don't worry. After speaking, he pulled up Sharon's little hand and ran towards his car. Sharon didn't expect that Lin Yu would even take his hand. A flush of shame suddenly appeared on his face. It's really annoying. Sharon couldn't help but grasp Lin Yu's hand tightly and ran out following Lin Yu. Behind them, Steve frowned slightly, then gritted his teeth and stomped his feet, and followed. In this place called SHIELD, it is really boring, so I might as well go out with these two people. After shopping, I took them to the hospital with myself. Lin Yu was slightly taken aback when he saw Steve following him. But, then I didn't bother to care about it. Just follow, Anyway, after Tony fights Obadiahstan, he has to go to the hospital with Steve. I came back to pick him up just to save time. Open the door, ignite, start. Camaro made a roar like a beast. With a kick of the accelerator, he disappeared into the night. Steve had seen such a fast car there, and he hurriedly grasped the handrail on the door of the car in fright, with a look of horror on his face. Sharon, the co-pilot, didn't worry at all about the speed of the speed. In her heart, she was still slightly happy. He actually grabbed his hand. The other side, Tony's good friend, Colonel Rod of the military, came to Tony's house as soon as he received a call from Tony's girlfriend Pepper Potts. At the moment, Tony has been snatched from the small arc reactor in his chest by Obadiahstan. Fortunately, Colonel Rod came in time. Only then did Tony's life be saved with the old small arc reactor. At the same time, Tony also anticipated that his girlfriend would be in danger. Regardless of the lack of energy in the old arc reactor, he put on a steel battle suit and flew to the Stark Industrial Building. And at the moment, Phil Coulson has already arrived inside the Stark Industrial Building because he set out first. Accompanying him are Tony's girlfriend, Pepper Potts, and several SHIELD agents. In a secret floor of the Stark Industrial Building, they discovered Obadiahstan, who had been wearing a steel battle suit. Compared with Tony's steel battle suit, Obadiahstan's battle suit is larger and has a richer weapon system. At first glance, it is a real killer. Phil Coulson brought a few agents with him, and he was not his opponent at all. Obadiahstan, who was wearing a steel battle suit, seemed to become even crazier. He has almost lost his mind. Chased out of the Stark Industrial Building and came to the street. Pedestrians on the road fled in fright. Recently, some weird things have always appeared in New York nights. Either the New York military base was attacked, or the three-headed dog fight in hell was abhorrent, and there were even dogs eating people on the street. So, this time there was a robot, and people seemed to take it off. The adaptability of the people of New York City has greatly improved. People on the road took out their phones and started taking pictures. Even more crazy reporters rushed all the way, came to the scene, and broadcast live. This kind of onlookers made Obadiahstan even more mad. He felt that he now wearing a steel battle suit is a god. All human beings will crawl under their feet. But at this time, in the distant sky, a stream of light suddenly appeared. A golden and red figure suddenly appeared. That figure is Tony Stark wearing a steel battle suit. When the two enemies met, they were extremely jealous. They fought together in an instant. That is, because Iron Man's energy is not sufficient, and he has a great disadvantage in terms of the weight of the battle suit. So, as soon as the war started, Tony was at a disadvantage. The fight between the two even came directly to the middle of the road. Obadiahstan directly lifted a car and slammed it at Tony. However, he was hit by the energy cannon in Tony's chest and flew out. But Obadiahstan's armor is extremely defensive, and it seems to have no effect at all when attacked. At this time, a small bright yellow sports car, galloping from a distance. Obadiahstan's eyes lit up and he stood on the road of the small sports car. Is there anyone who is not afraid of death? Then do the same, and use this car to give Tony a heavy blow. Far away, countless onlookers all saw the fast-moving Camaro. When seeing the steel giant standing in front of Camaro and lifting one of his big feet, everyone's mood suddenly started. That's it, the passengers in this car are going to die. In just a while, the steel giant had already destroyed several cars. Many people have been killed and injured. A series of terrifying explosions occurred across the road. The fire was blazing, and the smoke billowed. Is the driver in that Camaro blind? How could you not see such a tragic situation? Why did you rush over at all costs? The onlookers began to speculate. A reporter, facing the camera, has even interrupted the live broadcast that the car will crash. My friends in the audience, today is another sad day. We can see that the black robot is obviously the evil side. In the battle, he has destroyed countless cars and killed no fewer than dozens people. And the golden and red robot seems to be the righteous party, but his current situation is also precarious. He is not the opponent of the black robot at all. The reporter also couldn't tell whether the two fighting guys were robots or humans. After all, they are too armed. Oh, my goodness, a small yellow sports car rushed past, Don't you want to die? The reporter even pretended to cover his eyes. It seems that very bloody things will happen next. After all, several small cars have been crushed by that black robot before. At the moment, it's not just the crowds and reporters who are watching outside worrying about the Camaro. Steve, who was already extremely nervous in the car, started to feel his heart. Far away, Steve saw the two steel figures fighting. But Lin Yu never breaks, and the speed is getting faster and faster. It's as if it's going to die. When Steve first got in the car, he was taken aback by the speed at which Lin Yu drove. Now the soul is about to be scared away. He had also been in a car before he was frozen. But at that time, the fastest car was only a few dozen miles away. Moreover, Steve has just awakened from the ice, and his brain has not yet fully accepted the world. This speed of almost taking off is really hard for him to accept. Immediately afterwards, when he saw the two Iron Men fighting there, his head couldn't turn completely. Has this world developed to such an extent? There are actually robots. He originally thought that Lin Yu was just here to join in the fun and look from a distance. But, unexpectedly, Lin Yu had no intention of stopping at all. Moreover, there is no slowdown at all. Steve grabbed the armrest on the door with one hand, and grabbed the back of the front seat with the other, shouting in horror, "You, what do you want to do? Are you crazy?" Compared with Steve, Sharon is much calmer. It was not because she was brave, but because she had a strange trust in Lin Yu in her heart. She just felt that Lin Yu would not harm herself. So, her gaze never left Lin Yu's profile. Faced with such a situation, he can still maintain such a calmness. He is indeed the man he is fond of. At this tense moment, a nympho appeared in Sharon's heart. Lin Yu is naturally not stupid. Not to commit personal risks. Unless there is strong confidence and sufficient benefits. Just now, just when I saw Tony fighting Obadiastan. In Lin Yu's mind, the system prompt sounded. Ding, your car saw Tony Stark's steel battle suit technology from a distance, and felt jealous. You want to take a closer look at these magical technologies. When hearing this system prompt, Lin Yu was actually a little dazed. Is your car just jealous? Need a closer look? This is the first time Lin Yu has heard such system prompts. Is direct mutation bad, even close to the battlefield? Lin Yu frowned slightly, but made a decision in his heart immediately. Seeking wealth and insurance. Moreover, Lin Yu trusts his system extremely. So, go ahead. Then, there was a yellow Camaro rushing to the battlefield. Although Steve in the back seat was still yelling, Lin Yu seemed to turn a deaf ear. Regardless of the plot point or the upcoming mutation of Camaro, Lin Yu didn't want to let it go. Finally, just when Lin Yu drove the car to less than 100 meters from the battlefield, and Obadiastan had already noticed Lin Yu. In Lin Yu's mind, the system reminder finally sounded again. Ding, your car has learned Tony Stark's steel battle suit technology up close, and improved it across generations, and finally mutated into shapeshifting King Kong Autobot technology. Hear this system prompt. Lin Yu was overjoyed in his heart. This is awesome. In his previous life, Lin Yu, in addition to Marvel movies, also liked the shapeshifting King Kong series. Almost everyone has been brushed many times. The male protagonist in it has a Camaro who can transform into an Autobot, but Lin Yu was envious at the time. Did not expect. One day I can even own a shapeshifting King Kong. And, the most important thing is that after this car becomes an Autobot because of the system, it is absolutely loyal to itself. It's like Erha. Cool. Although the hero of the shapeshifting King Kong movie also owns a shapeshifting King Kong car, he will leave at any time. And his own Autobot, just like his pet dog, will never leave him alone. This is where his greatest advantage lies. At this moment, the Camaro driven by Lin Yu is no more than 50 meters away from Obadiastan. At this time, an electronic synthesis sound suddenly appeared in Lin Yu's car. Boss, sit down, I'm going to transform. This sudden sound shocked several people. Even Lin Yu was inexplicably sluggish. Unexpectedly, his shapeshifting King Kong could still speak. Dry, sure enough, I watched more movies. The protagonist in shapeshifting King Kong, the Bumblebee has been unable to speak because of a broken voice system. Lin Yu thought that his Autobots could not speak either. Lin Yu, who knew the actual situation, was shocked. Not to mention the two of Steve and Sharon. Tonight, Steve's whole body is not good. The worldview has been completely subverted. He only slept for 70 years, and he didn't expect that the car could even talk. Hear this voice. The appearance of Sharon's idiot disappeared instantly, and her face showed a dazed expression. Compared to this old antique Steve, she has a better understanding of the current world than most people. But, what is the sound that suddenly appeared in the boss's car? Say you want to transform. What the hell is this? Sharon looked at Lin Yu suspiciously. Is it possible that the boss has any other secrets? But, at this time, Lin Yu has no spare time to care about others. Bumblebee, show up. In the horrified eyes of Sharon and Steve, Camaro's dashboard suddenly cracked. Immediately afterwards, it's the roof of the car, the floor under the feet, the seat under the buttocks. All began to change wildly. Look from the outside. These two bright yellow little sports cars suddenly jumped up from the ground, and then suddenly shapeshifting in midair. Just a few seconds of effort. When it landed again, Lin Yu's car had become an Autobot who was taller than Obadiaston's steel battle suit and looked more sci-fi. The Autobot stopped in front of Obadiaston, about 10 meters away. And Lin Yu and others are sitting in the hands of Autobots. At this moment, the Autobot slowly bent down and placed the three of them on the ground. Run, what are you waiting for? Lin Yu yelled first and took the lead and ran away. Steve and Sharon, who had just recovered, also hurriedly followed Lin Yu and ran away. The picture on the battlefield suddenly became extremely strange. Especially for Obadiaston, the shock in his heart can no longer be described in words. He just stole Tony's small arc reactor and put on this steel battle suit. It was the time to be proud. But, when he saw the shapeshifting King Kong that was completely transformed from a car on the opposite side, he suddenly felt that what he was wearing was nothing but rubbish. The other party seems to have come out of a science fiction movie. And the steel battle suit that I am proud of is like a Joker. In this contrast, a judgment is made. At this time, Obadiaston slowly put down the foot he had just raised. He is also going to squash these two cars. But now he seems even more funny. Not far behind Obadiaston, Tony also stopped the attack. His appearance now looks more miserable. The steel battle suit on his body was scratched everywhere. Although the material of his steel battle suit is stronger, it is more than a star and a half thinner than the Obadiaston battle suit. At the moment, when he saw the sudden appearance of the shapeshifting King Kong, he was equally bewildered. Jarvis, show me the origin of this robot. Tony asked solemnly. If the opponent is also an enemy, then tonight will probably be a nightmare in New York City. Judging from the shapeshifting situation of the other party just now, the technology on that robot is definitely more advanced than the technology on Earth by at least 100 years. It's better not to be the enemy. Tony couldn't help but pray. After a few seconds, Jarvis's voice replied, "Boss, the shapeshifting technology of this robot cannot be ascertained. It is not within the scope of Earth's technology and is expected to exceed the current level of Earth's technology for more than 50 years. According to the license plate number of this car, it has been ascertained that the owner of this car is Lin Yu. He is an orphan and has a goddess. She lives on 58th Street in Manhattan. There is a grocery store under her name. There are 528 shares of Hanmer Industries. The ability of Jarvis is really strong." Within a few seconds, the hotel investigated everything on Lin Yu's face. But, when it said that Lin Yu held Hanmer Industries stock, Tony was in a bad shape. With the emergence of Autobots, the situation on the battlefield instantly became strangely quiet. The people watching the game around them also grew their mouths and their eyes widened in surprise. The face is incredible. They are all inside of the shapeshifting process of Lin Yu's car. From a distance, it looks like a miracle. A car turned out to be a robot. Moreover, it's so perfect. Let alone its combat effectiveness, just this process of transformation is enough to make everyone amazed. Except for the people at the scene. Countless people who saw this picture on the TV were also amazed. This night is destined to be another unforgettable day. And at the moment, on the battlefield, the Autobots finally spoke first. A voice without emotion came from his mouth. You wanted to take action against my master just now, unforgivable. The Autobot stretched out a hand and pointed to Obadiaston. In its eyes, nothing is more important than the life of its own master. And the guy in front of him, just now wanted to crush himself and his master with one foot. Really looking for death. Chapter 51. Hear these words from the Autobots. Tony smiled with joy. Obadiahstan was taken aback for a moment. Immediately afterwards, I saw that the hand extended by the Autobot suddenly changed its form. After a dazzling shapeshifting, that hand turned into a barrel. Obadiahstan was startled, ready to do something. But it was too late. Autobots shot extremely fast. A dazzling light lit up in the barrel, and then, a huge cannonball flew towards the steel battle suit of Obadiahstan. The speed of the shells is extremely fast. Although the steel battle suit of Obadiahstan is very strong, it is weak in terms of speed. Seeing the cannonball came in front of him, but he couldn't avoid it at all. Boom! The violent explosion sounded throughout the sky. After a dazzling fire, Obadiahstan's figure was instantly knocked away several meters away. The armor on his body has become dented. An arm has also been hanging softly on his side. It seems to be broken. Although his steel battle suit is made of thick materials and strong defenses, it is still unable to withstand the attacks of Autobots that surpass the Earth's technology. At this moment, Obadiahstan in the steel battle suit showed extreme horror on his face. I can't hold my own steel battle suit at all. Obadiahstan panicked completely. The original arrogance in his heart has completely disappeared. At the moment, there is only panic in my heart, and the desire to escape. At this moment, under Obadiahstan's armor suddenly changed its shape and burned into flames. He used the flight function on his steel battle suit. Ready to escape. After seeing this scene, Tony behind him secretly said badly. He didn't expect that the steel battle suit of Obadiahstan could even fly. This is troublesome. If you own the newest small arc reactor, you might be able to catch up with the opponent. But now, the energy of this old-fashioned arc reactor in his chest is simply not enough to support his battle suit for a long flight. At this time, Obadiahstan's steel battle suit began to slowly lift off. Obadiahstan is betting that the robot that the car turns into can't fly. Nor can it be regarded as a pure bet, because he no longer has any backups. His own steel battle suit is not the opponent of that Autobot at all. He can only choose to escape. If you can run away, even if you take another shot while flying in the sky, it's worth it. After you escape, you can make a comeback. He had secretly transferred his property a long time ago. As long as people are there and possessing the technology of steel battle suit, they are still a hero. At the moment, on the ground, the weapon that the Autobot's arm turned into was again replaced with the shape of a palm. He has only one shot of this powerful missile. And it really can't fly, because he hasn't learned it yet. However, watching Obadiahstan controlling the steel battle suit has begun to lift off, the Autobots are not in any rush. It seems that I don't care at all. Ding, your shapeshifting King Kong has closely learned Tony Stark's steel battle suit flight technology, and has made innovations, and learned the Autobot-assisted flight technology. Lin Yu, who was hiding in the corner watching the battle, once again sounded the system reminder in his mind. On the battlefield, the Autobot Camaro had turned into suddenly stepped on a pickup truck next to him with one foot. Then, a strange scene happened. That pickup truck suddenly mutated. It quickly changed its shape, transformed into a lot of strange parts, and then climbed up along the Autobot's legs. Finally, staying on the back of the Autobot, it became a huge amount of wings. In the center of that wing, there are two huge amounts of flamethrower. The Autobots learned flight ability in an instant. At the moment, Obadiahstan has lifted off. His figure gradually got farther and farther away from the ground. And Obadiahstan in the steel battle suit gradually showed a smile on his face. There seems to be a feeling of being left behind. But, at the moment, there was a sudden tremor in his heart. A yellow figure suddenly rose into the sky, approaching him quickly. The opponent's flight speed was more than twice faster than his own. No, the flight speed of the two is not the same level at all. The distance between the two is rapidly getting closer. The smile on Obadiahstan's face gradually solidified. In his line of sight, you can clearly see that the other party has pulled out a long sword glowing with cold light from his back. This robot is still a soldier. Obadiah's heart was completely cold. He tried his best to inject all the energy into the two thrusters under his feet. But, the figure of the Autobot is still fast approaching. Finally, in everyone's eyes, they caught up with Obadiaston wearing a steel battle suit. A cold light suddenly lit up. The Autobot waved the long sword in his hand. The knife in the Autobot's hand looks unpretentious, like a very ordinary long knife. It just seems that there is a sci-fi-like feeling in the knife handle and other places. It didn't feel sharp either. But, when the blade of the long knife touched Obadiaston's steel battle suit, suddenly, it cut off. It's like chopped on tofu. The steel battle suit, which was originally extremely defensive, was instantly cut in half from top to bottom under the knife of the Autobots. Boom, boom, the sound of two heavy objects falling to the ground frightened the surrounding crowd hurriedly backed up a few steps. This battle is really too fast. From the appearance of the Autobots to the injury of Obadiaston. Then he escaped, and then he was split in half with a sword. This process took less than 2 minutes. The battle is over. Already split in half, Obadiaston, who fell to the ground, is probably dead and dead. The people watching from a distance, through the camera on the mobile phone, finally saw the human in the armor of the machine. They finally understood that the first two robots were actually humans wearing a steel battle suit. And the other one, the Autobot that appeared last, was not a human. It's a simple robot. At this moment, the Autobots in the sky finally fell slowly. After landing, the propellers and wings on his back, as if the mission was over, turned into a pile of broken parts and fell to the ground. Standing quietly on the ground, the Autobots did not move. Seems to be waiting for something. At this moment, Lin Yu, who was hiding in the corner with Sharon and Steve, suddenly rang his phone. Lin Yu picked up the phone in confusion. Inside came the familiar electronic synthesis sound. Boss, one has already been solved, but has the other need be taken out at the same time? Lin Yu was taken aback for a moment, and then he realized. My Autobot still makes phone calls. Lin Yu stood on tiptoe, glanced at Iron Man Tony in the distance, and then said, forget it, that's a friendly army for the time being. Obadiaston must die. After all, this guy sent someone to assassinate himself. And just now I was going to crush myself and my car with my feet. But Tony Stark let it go. I have to buy his stock to make money. Moreover, Iron Man seems to be his idol. Hearing Lin Yu's order, the Autobots turned into place without hesitation, from the Autobot form to a handsome Camaro again. The gorgeous transformation process once again amazed the people around and the audience watching the live broadcast in front of the TV. Even Tony, who stood in a daze and looked at a loss, was envious of the abnormality. He was completely stunned by this wonderful battle. The movement of shapeshifting King Kong made a huge wave in his heart. In front of the shapeshifting King Kong, the steel battle suit he was proud of seemed a bit naive. But, it is different from Obadiaston. Obadiaston just stole Tony's design. However, Tony Stark really has this technology. After seeing the shapeshifting King Kong, his brain was as dazzling as fireworks. He has thought of many ideas to make his steel battle suit stronger. These ideas are all thought of after seeing shapeshifting King Kong. Even Lin Yu didn't know that the appearance of Autobots would affect Tony's steel battle suit. At this moment, after the Autobots changed back to the form of a car, a dashing drift, galloping out directly. 10 seconds later, he stopped in front of Lin Yu and others who were hiding in the darkness. The lights of the car completely exposed the three figures in everyone's sight. Lin Yu secretly said a bad word in his heart, and pulled Sharon into the car hurriedly. The reaction speed is extremely fast. Immediately afterwards, countless flashes suddenly flashed around. And Steve was not so cautious anymore. He scanned the surrounding circle slowly before getting into the car slowly. But, just after a while, Steve was standing next to the Camaro that could turn into an Autobot, with his head up and chest tall, and he was already photographed by countless people. When Lin Yu came in a car before, everyone was attracted by the handsome shapeshifting of the Autobots. Almost no one noticed the appearance of Lin Yu. But this time is different. It's almost like Steve has put up a pose for everyone to take pictures of him. When Steve got in the car, Camaro broke out with a beast-like roar again. It turned into a yellow streamer and galloped out. The speed in the recent past seems to be a bit faster. But, Lin Yu sitting in the driver's seat did not even grasp the steering wheel. The foot didn't step on the accelerator either. Just said something and arranged it, and the Autobots set off on their own. It's not too convenient. This is much cooler than the autonomous driving developed by humans. And, with the Autobots, Lin Yu is not at all worried about collisions or other things. As a shapeshifting King Kong, if a traffic accident can happen if you drive by yourself, it would be really funny. I'll give you a name. Lin Yu sat in the car comfortably and said casually. Good boss. The Autobots did not refuse to come. Well, you call it Bumblebee. Good boss. Lin Yu is not good at naming things. But, fortunately, there is no shapeshifting King Kong movie in this world. Giving him the name of Bumblebee, it's not a duplicate name. Ding, congratulations to the host for participating in the core Marvel plot, Steel Tony vs. Steel Obadiah, 100% participation and 5 plot points. Several people have just left the battlefield. In Lin Yu's mind, the system prompt sounded again. In this plot, I actually got 5 plot points directly. Lin Yu was so happy. After seeing Steve before, Lin Yu's plot point has reached 6 points. And now, it directly became 11 o'clock. It only takes 9 plot points to advance to level 4 from the system. Go to the hospital, and see my idol, Ms. Peggy Cat. Lin Yu said excitedly. Lin Yu just finished speaking. The Hornet's speed has increased a bit faster again. He didn't even need the road, turned a corner, and drove naturally in the direction of the hospital where Peggy Cat was. As a shapeshifting King Kong, he is not only strong in combat. He can easily access the internet on the Earth to find the information he needs. When Lin Yu said Peggy Cat's name, Bumblebee instantly found Peggy Cat's location on the internet. But, at the moment, in the entire carriage, only Lin Yu looked more natural. Sharon and Steve haven't said a word since they got in the car. They sat in the car quietly, not daring to move their hands and feet, and seemed a little frightened. Definitely, they can't be blamed for this. After all, the two Camaros just turned into a robot, not only capable of talking, but also so powerful. It even cut Obadiaston in half with a sword in front of them. And now, they actually sat inside the belly of this robot. This not only makes their brains think about it. If you accidentally kick this car, will it be eaten directly? The more I think about it, the more terrifying it becomes. Thinking about it, the two became even more cramped. In the entire carriage, only Lin Yu felt here and knocked there, as if he was not afraid of death at all. Lin Yu and others left. Tony Stark on the battlefield also quietly left. Only countless onlookers were left behind, unable to turn around for a long time in the cold wind. This robot war finally came to an end. But, on the internet, there was an uproar. People in the Marvel world discovered for the first time that there are such high-tech things on the Earth. Forget those two guys wearing steel battle suits. After all, he was just wearing a suit made of steel. It is completely within the scope of technology acceptable to people. But, that Autobot is different. There is no shapeshifting of King Kong movies and comics in this world. So, the appearance of Autobots completely detonated the entire network. Countless netizens started big discussions on the internet. There are countless scientists who have stood up, saying that such technological methods are definitely not what should exist on the Earth. It is the probability of alien technology, almost 99%. Except for the discussion of Autobots. The ownership of this car has also become a hot topic of discussion. Especially the last photo. A man with a tall stature and a firm face stood quietly next to Camaro, who had become an Autobot. Strong male hormones exuded all over his body. In an instant, they captured the hearts of thousands of girls. Immediately, people picked out the identity of this person. He looks exactly the same as the captain of the United States who had been sacrificed 70 years ago. Oh my, the entire network is boiling. Subsequently, someone picked up an announcement made before the United States Captain Memorial Hall. The content of the announcement is, the body of the captain of the United States was found frozen in the Arctic Glacier, and the salvage work is now in progress. The United States Captain Memorial Hall is dedicated to commemorate the United States Captain Steve Rogers. Usually, some schools will organize students to visit there, and the flow of people is very small. As for their official website, no one will read it. But, the power of netizens is great. When this announcement was posted on the internet, people finally started to discover. The guy standing next to Camaro seems to be the captain of the United States, Steve. He is still alive. Moreover, they have such terrifying technological power. For a time, the internet was surging. Even SHIELD and the United States officials have nothing to do with these rumors. As for the other major event that happened that night, very few people paid attention. Although another thing is also great. The New York military base was tragically destroyed, countless tanks and planes were destroyed, hundreds of soldiers were slaughtered, and all this was caused by three terrifying green monsters. This matter, if placed elsewhere, will definitely detonate the internet. But, under the two hot spots of Captain of the United States Resurrection and Shapeshifting Camaro, it failed to make a splash on the internet. New York military base. After the toss of three Airha, the New York military base at the moment has completely turned into a ruin. Compared to the last time, this time it was destroyed more thoroughly. All the vehicles and planes above the military base, not one left, all turned into scrap copper and iron. Regarding Lin Yu's orders, Airha performed well. No Choi has been missed. Except for the facilities on the ground. The secret underground base hidden in the ground also suffered serious losses. Under Erha's sensitive nose, there is nowhere to hide. But, the building below is indeed a bit narrow. As a result, Airha just sprayed a few flames into it at will, and then stopped. But, just these few flames were about to kill General Ross. Although the underground base is like a maze, it is intricate. But, the flame spitting out of Erha's mouth is really too hot. Although the scorching flame did not directly burn General Rose's body, it also roasted his skin almost to a black charcoal color. Hair and eyebrows were not spared either. With the exception of one more eye than Nick Fury, General Ross at the moment is already infinitely close to Nick Fury. When the support from other military bases arrived, the three Erhas had become one again, and the body had recovered to its original file size and disappeared into the night along the small woods next to it. Because the New York military base is not too far away from New York City. So, the military wants to find Airha in the huge New York City. Afterwards, according to statistics, the number of deaths at the New York military base this time has reached a terrifying 200 people. More people were injured. Most of them were scalded by the hot flames. But, after cleaning the battlefield, the military found that the dead 200 people, but only found the bodies of less than 100 people. In other words, the corpses of 100 people were eaten by those three terrifying monsters. After the two have become three, it seems that the appetite has also become larger. Even Lin Yu doesn't know why its stomach can be released by so many people. The next day, Washington, D.C., in an office in the Pentagon. General Ross is receiving inquiries from the top executives of the United States. But, at the moment General Rose's face seemed a little ugly. Because of your mistake, the New York military base has suffered even more losses this time. I will give you 3 minutes to defend. If there is no good reason, then you can retire. Even if General Ross is the true leader of the military, the high-level military will never take lightly for this level of loss. It's not me that caused these losses, but the three monsters and the guy who instigated those monsters. In the face of that kind of power, ordinary soldiers can't stop them, and they can't blame me for all the responsibilities. General Rose said angrily. This time, he really lost his wife and broke down. Lost everyone in the eyes of my colleagues. As for the guy named Lin Yu, we will find SHIELD to settle the accounts, but we have already investigated, and you provoked him. Above, the high-level cold voice came again. But, this sentence made General Rose a little surprised. He really wanted to kill him first. But, SHIELD, what does this matter have to do with SHIELD? General Ross asked. When you provoke him, he just became an honorary consultant of SHIELD. General Rose narrowed his eyes. SHIELD, it turns out that there are also SHIELD tricks. That nasty black charcoal head is simply living impatiently. The anger in General Rose's heart grew stronger. But, he knows that the most important thing for him now is to keep his identity. Only with greater power can we retaliate against Lin Yu and Nick Fury. At this moment, General Ross slowly took out a USB flash drive from his pocket and handed it to the upper management. Then he said coldly, "My super soldier plan has been completed. There are some information about the super soldier. If the military has an army composed entirely of super soldiers, Millikan will become great again. Millikan became great again, this is a reason that cannot be rejected. General Ross hadn't planned to report this super soldier plan. But, if you don't report now, I'm afraid you won't be able to keep your power. After reading the information on the USB flash drive, the high-level military officials showed surprises on their faces. The USB flash drive clearly explained all the information about the super soldier that General Ross had successfully researched. Every one of those super soldiers with greenish skin is extremely strong. If you really have an army composed entirely of such soldiers, there will be no army in the world that can compete with the United States military. This is a temptation of huge amounts of. After a brief discussion among the military's senior officials. Finally, the person in the center spoke slowly. Okay, but you only have one chance, you can only succeed and not fail. Lin Yu did not care too much about the life and death of General Ross. A small military general, for Lin Yu now, is not worth paying too much attention to. Last night, after the Autobots killed Obadiestin with a single sword, Lin Yu took Sharon and Steve to the hospital. In the hospital, Lin Yu naturally gained Peggy Cat's plot points easily. As for idols, Sharon didn't see any excitement when Lin Yu saw his aunt anyway. After meeting, Lin Yu quietly left with Sharon. Only Steve, who is a little bewildered, is left with his girlfriend who has been older than him for several reincarnations. This time out, Lin Yu gained a lot. At the moment's Lin Yu, there are already two very powerful third-level mutants around him. One is the three-headed dog in the green hell that can become three. The other is the bumblebee that just killed Obadiestin easily. In Lin Yu's eyes, a line of small print has also appeared above this Camaro. Name, car, variation direction, Autobot technology. Variation level, third order. Anomaly, an Autobot alone is not very powerful. Having a shapeshifting King Kong team and obtaining the source of fire is the strongest state of shapeshifting King Kong. Quote, looking at the small print above his Camaro, Lin Yu was lost in thought. Perhaps, I should hurry up and make some money, and then buy a few more cars. Maybe someday a shapeshifting King Kong team will come out. But, if you want to buy so many cars, it is estimated that you have to change to a big house first. There is only a small garage next to my small grocery store, so I can't leave so many cars. Definitely, there is one more important question. That is, will Wanda, the little money fan, pay for it? Early morning, Lin Yu shouted to Sharon, who had just arrived, and was about to go out again. Because today there is one more important thing. That is, the press conference of Stark Industries. Yesterday's battle, after all, appeared in the Stark Industrial Building, which had a great impact on society. As a conscientious weapons manufacturer, we must hold a press conference to express our attitude. And this conference, for Lin Yu, is another good opportunity to get plot points. As for why I brought Sharon. Naturally, Sharon, the identity of the SHIELD high-level agent, can provide Lin Yu with a lot of convenience. But, Wanda expressed great dissatisfaction with Lin Yu taking Sharon out for two consecutive days. But, after all, Sharon had just rescued her brother from the killer's hands. Wanda is not good at Sharon. Then, he pointed the finger at Lin Yu. Brother, why do you always take Sharon out instead of me? Are you disgusting me? Wanda pouted and said angrily. The thing she fears most is that Lin Yu is no longer as good to her as before. When in the orphanage, Wanda and Lin Yu were very close. In Wanda's heart, Lin Yu is the only relative. So, as long as Lin Yu's attitude towards her changes a little, she can feel it. Hearing Wanda's words, Lin Yu's heart trembled. The little girl is going crazy again. No, the fire must be put out before she runs away. Lin Yu scratched his head, smiled honestly, and said, actually, I want to take you there too, but the business in our shop has been a bit good lately. There are hundreds or thousands of dollars a day. Who will make money if you go out? What about the money? Wanda frowned slightly. It seems that what my brother said is quite reasonable. But, then I thought, it's not right. Then you don't want to go, help me in the store. Wanda pouted again. Lin Yu was a bit big head for a while. But, lived with Wanda for so long. Nothing else, can you coax children? Lin Yu hurriedly took out his mobile phone from his pocket, opened the stock trading software, and shook it in front of Wanda. Then he said, look, I'm not going out to make money for you. The shares of Hanmer Industries I bought before have not risen much. I will check Stark Industries so I can decide whether to buy their stocks. Lin Yu's excuse is seamless. Even Wanda couldn't fault it. Moreover, as long as she can make money, she will probably consider selling Lin Yu. Okay, then you guys will come back soon. Wanda thought for a while, and finally put the dollar position in front of Lin Yu. Hearing Wanda's consent, Lin Yu's face was overjoyed. He hurriedly put the glasses he was holding on to his face, then grabbed Sharon's hand and ran to the door. The press conference of Stark Industries is about to begin, and Lin Yu is a little anxious. Did not think too much. But, Lin Yu pulled Sharon and ran out of the door when he heard Wanda's roar in the grocery store. Let me go. It's not just the roar. Lin Yu even saw the red light shining in the grocery store from the corner of his eye. Lin Yu's small heart trembled suddenly. This little girl is going crazy. Scarlet Witch's ability is all used. Lin Yu was so scared that he didn't even turn his head back, and hurriedly got into the car. Without Lin Yu's fire, the Hornet had already uttered a fierce roar and shot out. Sarong, who was sitting in the co-pilot, also seemed to have lingering fears. He patted her chest and asked softly, "Boss, are you sure Wanda won't tear down the grocery store?" Lin Yu looked at Sharon and held his glasses, his mood slowly calmed down. "No, in her eyes, my status is not as good as a profitable grocery store." When Lin Yu and Sharon walked into the press conference, Tony Stark was on the podium, looking at the note in his hand, reading the speech written by Colonel Rhodes. But, at the moment Tony was obviously absent-minded. Colonel Rhodes, who was standing by, hurried to Tony's ear and reminded, "Don't talk nonsense, just read it from the manuscript." Tony nodded slightly at Colonel Rhodes. But he couldn't control his mouth more and more, and he was a little excited. The truth is, the corners of Tony's mouth gradually cocked. "I am Iron Man." Wow, the entire venue was completely messed up. Colonel Rhodes' face next to Tony turned black. Pepper Potts, who was standing at the entrance of the venue, also widened his eyes. Unexpectedly, Tony would admit his identity on the spot. As the audience remembered, they all stood up, raised the microphone in their hands, and asked in a mess. Compared to those high-sounding speeches, what they most want to hear is this kind of explosive news. During this period, many major events have happened in New York. And those reporters who reported in the first time have gained great benefits. Obviously, the news this time is even more explosive than the previous chaos. The boss of Starka Industries, the largest weapons manufacturer in the country, admitted at a press conference that he is Iron Man. Oh my, this world is crazy. Iron Man, this name is too domineering. As Iron Man, the domineering yellow robot last night, a trainee reporter hurriedly asked his mentor. On the side, a middle-aged reporter said without looking back, "Definitely is that robot. Is it possible that someone else would dare to call such a domineering name?" After the trainee reporter heard the tutor's answer, his eyes became brighter and brighter. After watching the news yesterday, he was already a fan of that yellow robot. That handsome transformation, powerful combat power, and upright posture almost made him crazy. It turned out that this robot was made by Tony Stark. In an instant, Tony also became the idol of this trainee reporter. "Mr. Stark, how did you make such a powerful mecha? Mr. Stark, how did you get such advanced technology? Mr. Stark, with such a powerful force, what would you use it for? Mr. Stark." Below the venue, reporters shouted hysterically. I hope Tony Stark can answer their own questions first. On the podium, Tony smiled and seemed to enjoy this world-renowned moment. He was a person who didn't like Loki since he was a child. No matter what he does, he likes to have a group of people around him. Definitely, it would be even better if I could compliment it a little bit. Subsequently, Tony ignored his old friend Colonel Rhodes' obstruction, and directly clicked on a reporter, and then said, "You come to ask." This reporter happened to be the craziest intern reporter just called. Being spotted by Tony, the trainee reporter was overjoyed. Hurriedly asked loudly, "Mr. Stark, I am your fan." Hearing the first words of the trainee reporter, Tony showed a happy expression on his face. His character just likes to be public. I also enjoy the feeling of being regarded as an idol. Tony smiled slightly and gave the trainee reporter an encouraging look. Ruzi can teach. The trainee reporter is getting more excited. Mr. Stark, what I want to ask is, How did you control that shape-shifting car robot in the battle yesterday? Oh no, it's Iron Man. How did you control that yellow Iron Man car? Upon hearing this question, the reporters below also hurriedly pricked up their ears and opened their eyes wide. It seems that Tony Stark's answer is extremely anticipated. They are also very curious about how the Autobots were controlled last night. Seeing how the robot transformed yesterday, Tony Stark shouldn't be in the robot's body. He estimated that something was remotely operated at a distance. But, after hearing the question from the trainee reporter, Tony's face suddenly changed when he was standing on the podium. Shapeshifting car robot, Iron Man car, what the hell is this? How do you feel that this guy is not talking about himself? Tony's brows gradually frowned. This seems a bit misunderstanding. What I said was not the Autobot who killed Obadiah Thin in the end. But at the very beginning, on the battlefield, he killed the Iron Man who was kicked off Obadiah. Tony suddenly felt a bit panicked. Ding, congratulations to the host for participating in the General Story Iron Man official debut press conference and earning 2 plot points. Lin Yu hid in the corner, watching Tony's performance quietly. In his mind, the system reminder finally sounded. 2 plot points, get it. In addition to the previous plot points, at the moment Lin Yu, the plot point has reached 13 points. It's not too far to advance to the 4-level system. But, when Lin Yu was about to leave, he heard the trainee reporter's question. He walked to the body outside the door and gave a sudden stop. A strange smile appeared on his face. Now, Tony doesn't seem to be able to step down. Lin Yu took Sharon's hand, turned and walked back. There seems to be a good show, it's started. Lin Yu can clearly see the bitter expression on Tony's face. Nor can we blame the reporters for misunderstanding. The battle just ended yesterday, and Tony announced that he was Iron Man early this morning. But, the most eye-catching thing last night was not Tony wearing a steel battle suit, but his own Bumblebee. Although Sharon on the side wondered why Lin Yu left but came back. But, at the moment, she couldn't control so much. I don't know if Lin Yu has forgotten, or deliberately, holding his own hand, he has not let go. Sharon blushed and didn't hear a word during the press conference. A few days later, Nick Fury, who had been stunned by the photo of Steve and the Hornet, suddenly received a report from his subordinates. In a secret base of S.H.I.E.L.D., Tesseract, which is being studied by Doctor of Astronomy and Dr. Eric, Thor's old friend, suddenly appeared abnormal. It seems that it was activated by something. Nick Fury, who received the report, hurried to this secret base by helicopter. Tesseract's research has been going on for a long time. Through researching Tesseract, S.H.I.E.L.D. has begun to make the second stage of powerful weapons and equipment in order to deal with various threats from alien planets. But, did not expect. Just when Nick Fury came here, Tesseract suddenly shot a light. In the S.H.I.E.L.D. underground base, a small portal was formed. After a few seconds, the portal slowly dissipated. On the ground, a handheld scepter appeared, like a guy who had just participated in a fancy dress party. Loki finally came to the Earth. And, after controlling Hawkeye Barton, Dr. Eric, and several S.H.I.E.L.D. agents with the Mind Scepter in his hand, he left. S.H.I.E.L.D. suffered heavy losses. The entire base collapsed. Dozens of S.H.I.E.L.D. staff were buried underground. Even the core high-level agent Hill almost killed you. For a while, S.H.I.E.L.D. was screaming. Faced with Loki's arrival, Nick Fury decisively issued an order to search the world for the whereabouts of Loki's Tesseract. At the same time, Nick Fury also reported this incident to the World Security Council. The main duty of the World Security Council was originally established to supervise S.H.I.E.L.D. At the moment, Pierce has not yet become a minister of the World Security Council. In a secret meeting room of the S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier. On several big screens, there is a director of the World Security Council. At the moment, one of the directors said, "So you should do your best to develop the second stage weapon, it is precisely for this situation." Before he finished speaking, Nick Fury interrupted. "The research on the second phase of weapons has not been completed, but the enemy has arrived. We need an emergency team," Nick Fury said calmly. Several members of the World Security Council said, "The Avengers project has been suspended. Moreover, we have seen that list. You have a first-class secret agent organization in your hands, but are you going to hand over the fate of mankind to a group of freaks?" On the list, there is even the owner of the grocery store who attacked the New York military base. Do you think he is qualified to participate in this kind of operation to save all mankind? Speaking of Lin Yu, Nick Fury was suddenly excited. You think that people are willing to save the world? I worked hard to get him to agree to join Avengers. You don't even know how strong his true power is, just command here blindly. The Earth will be destroyed in the hands of you guys sooner or later. Nick Fury was extremely angry. These guys sit in the office every day and don't know what's going on. They only know to make trouble for themselves. Regarding the list of Avengers members, Nick Fury has already drawn up. There are Black Widow Natasha Romanoff, Hawkeye Barton, Captain Steve of the United States, Dr. Bruce Banner the Hulk, Iron Man Tony Stark, and even Thor of Asgard can be regarded as half uncertain foreign aid. But, these people are scumbags in front of Lin Yu. Of the Avengers, only Lin Yu is the most important. Because, Nick Fury knows the power Lin Yu can control. Although he originally looked like a thin boy, no matter whether it was the Erha, the car, or his little sister Wanda, he was a terrifying force. Nick Fury slammed the door and walked straight out of the meeting room. Since they disagree, then I don't bother to pay attention to them. Regardless of what messes will happen in the future, the most important thing is to get through this crisis first. And if you want to survive this crisis, you must gather these powerful forces. Hill, please inform Lin Yu and tell him to come as soon as possible. Nick Fury said to the Hill agent next to him. Hill was taken aback for a moment, and then asked, Boss, isn't Sharon by his side? Why don't you ask Sharon to speak to him directly? Hearing Sharon's name, Nick Fury sighed slightly and said, Sharon, I am already Lin Yu's person. What about Phil Coulson and Natasha Romanoff? Although Hill didn't quite understand what Chief Fury meant, he didn't continue to ask Sharon about it, but asked the other two people. Because, generally, this kind of task is not done by herself, so she will ask. Hill's responsibilities are mainly internal. And Natasha Romanoff and Phil Coulson are the main agents that perform tasks outside. But, hear Hill's question, Nick Fury sighed again, and said, the last time they went. Forget it, don't ask, you can go if you ask you to go. Under the arrangement of Nick Fury, SHIELD and many high-level agents began to contact Avengers members that they had decided on. Natasha Romanoff went to Kolkata to visit Dr. Bruce Banner, who had been monitored by SHIELD. Phil Coulson went to Stark Industrial Building and invited Tony Stark, who had declared himself to be Iron Man. Nick Fury himself went to chat with the Captain of the United States. At the moment, the Captain of the United States has gradually adapted to his current life. It just seemed a little empty. He was originally a soldier, and he didn't have much opinion on the work arrangements of his superiors. As for Lin Yu, Hill agent hesitation repeatedly, or went to the grocery store at Manhattan Avenue alone. She actually refused in her heart. After all, even after Natasha Romanoff and Phil Coulson went to the store, they seemed a little nervous. Can I be spared? Hill agent is not sure. But, she could not violate the chief's order. So, she was well prepared. The words that I should have said are thoroughly cooked by memorizing. When I got there, I didn't say anything extra. After saying what you want to express, leave quickly. Resolutely don't talk much, don't stay too much. Ding, congratulations to Speed for meeting the Hill agent, the core supporting role in the Marvel world. You will be rewarded with one plot point. As soon as Hill walked into the door of the grocery store, Lin Yu received the system prompt. Lin Yu was slightly taken aback while playing the game while lying prone in front of the computer screen. Does Nick Fury know his hobby? Why do you always send your female agent to your side? Is it possible that you want to use a Gentletown strategy to make yourself surrender to him? Lin Yu frowned slightly. This trick, I am afraid I really can't stand it. Thinking of this, Lin Yu hurriedly stopped the game in his hand, then took out his glasses from his jacket pocket and put them on his face. Then, stepped out from behind the bar and greeted him. At this time, it was still early in the morning, and the customers had not yet begun to come. So, the whole shop was deserted. Hill agent walked into the grocery store, looked around, and looked at the environment in the grocery store. As a high-level agent, she will be familiar with the on-site environment wherever she goes. Although this mission is not a combat mission, he has heard too much about Lin Yu during this period. Nothing happened to Lin Yu is normal. This also made her very vigilant. Lin Yu walked over, stretched out a hand at Hill, and said with a smile, "Isn't this Chief Fury's favorite general, Maria Hill? Welcome, welcome." Hill agent frowned slightly, "You even know my name?" As soon as Hill said what he said, he hurriedly covered his mouth. "I almost forgot, I can't talk nonsense. At the moment." Lin Yu's hand has reached out in front of Hill. Although she was very reluctant, she could only reach out and hold Lin Yu together. Click to stop. "I'm here this time," Hill was ready to get straight to the subject. But, Lin Yu is not a polite person. It's really out of order for someone to come here for the first time without hiring Roar. "Sharon, pour a cup of tea for the guests," Lin Yu shouted to the upstairs. As a Chinese, tea is of course indispensable to entertain guests. But, hear what Lin Yu said. Hill was taken aback again. "Sharon, I came so early, is Sharon already at work at this time?" Not long after Lin Yu's voice fell, Sharon, with a bun on his head and an apron, walked down from the second floor with a cup of tea. Seeing it turned out to be an old friend Hill agent, a gentle smile appeared on his face. But, Hill's expression is a bit exaggerated. "What? Sharon is wearing an apron. How do you look like a housewife?" "Shaw, Sharon, what were you doing just now?" Hill agent asked dumbfounded. Passing the water glass in her hand to Hill, who was sluggish, Sharon smiled and said openly, "I'm cooking for the boss, otherwise what to eat in the morning?" At this time, Hill seems to have forgotten his decision not to talk nonsense. Some dumbfounded asked, "Aren't you his assistant? Why are you still in charge of cooking?" Sharon's current behavior, as well as her dress, have completely exceeded Hill's imagination. This SHIELD high-level agent who worked with him turned out to be like this. "The sun is coming out from the west. Since I am an assistant, I definitely did everything." Sharon made no secret of her satisfaction with her current job. "But, it's not the time to go to work yet," Hill asked weakly again. "Even when SHIELD goes to work, he won't go to work so early. I came early to avoid the time period when the customers are relatively large." At this moment, Lin Yu suddenly took the conversation. "Oh, in order to be able to work better, Sharon now lives here." Hill's brain is blank, looking at this familiar and unfamiliar colleague in front of me. She has no idea what to say. This Lin Yu is really weird. This grocery store is really not where normal people should come. Hill carefully put the tea in his hand on the table. "She dare not drink from here. Mr. Lin, oh no, Counselor Lin, this time I came because the director wanted to invite you to the SHIELD headquarters to discuss how to deal with alien invaders. This is information about the intruder Loki and Tesseract, you can take a look first." Hill handed the prepared materials in front of Lin Yu. Lin Yu took it naturally. But he didn't rush to read the text on the information. "Regarding Loki and Tesseract, I am afraid that SHIELD does not know much about it." Just when Hill was about to say goodbye, upstairs, another woman's voice came. Wearing the same apron as Sharon, Wanda walked down the stairs with breakfast. Lin Yu didn't look back, knowing that the two women finally had breakfast ready. He smiled at Hill and said, "Stay and have breakfast before leaving." "Hear Lin Yu's invitation." Hill's head hurriedly shook like a rattle. He waved his hands hurriedly and said, "No, no, I have something to do. There is my phone number on this card. If you have time, call me and I will pick you up again." Hill pulled out a black business card from his pocket. There is not much text on the business card. There is only a sign of SHIELD and a telephone number. She should have picked up Lin Yu this time. But she has no idea what to say now. Just want to quickly escape from this weird place. What if I stay here for a long time and become like Sharon? Lin Yu smiled slightly and took the business card with his polite hands. Then, take off the glasses, turned to Wanda, who had just come down from the stairs, he said, "I will introduce you, this is the SHIELD high-level agent, Sharon's colleague, Miss Hill." Hill is suffering in his heart now. She wanted to leave this weird place as soon as possible. But, Wanda hastily put down the plate in her hand and stretched out her hand. Hill can only reach out and hold Wanda together. At this moment, Wanda suddenly took Hill's hand and said with a smile, "Look, you don't even have a business card holder. It's so inconvenient. It just happens that our store has a new batch of beautiful business card holders. I will show you it. Wanda's business, that is quite skilled. When Hill heard Wanda's words, he wanted to hurriedly refuse. What business card holder? I brought this business card specially for Lin Yu's visit. An agent of my own, where do I usually bring such things as business cards? Not to mention the business card holder. But. Then think again. Indeed, I seem to be missing a business card holder. Although there are not many opportunities to use business cards. However, it is not impossible to buy one prepared. We're all at the grocery store, can't you just buy one by the way? Hill frowned, and slowly said, it's okay to take a look. Hill eventually left by himself. Lin Yu didn't seem to be anxious about going to the shield space carrier. Lin Yu is naturally not in a hurry. Because, Lin Yu, who is familiar with Marvel's plot, knows that if he goes now, he will definitely not see everyone. It's better to wait for everyone from Avengers and Loki to get together, and then go. By the time, the system is estimated to be able to upgrade. And at the moment, on the shield space carrier, Dr. Bruce Banner, Tony Stark, Natasha Romanoff, Steve are all present. Except for Hawkeye and Lin Yu, basically Avengers members have all gathered. As for Thor, Nick Fury has not yet considered him a member of Avengers. In the main control room of the space carrier, seeing that Hill agent came back by himself without bringing Lin Yu, Nick Fury frowned and asked, Hill, what's the situation with you? Where is Consultant Lin? On Hill's road, the most scared thing is that the chief asks himself. Because, 690, she really couldn't think of an explanation. Director, I have already made it clear to Consultant Lin, and will call me when he wants to come, and I will pick him up again. Hearing Hill agent's answer, Nick Fury frowned slightly. But it was also expected. This Lin Yu has been in contact with him several times. He is not someone who can be moved casually. I hope he can appear in time when there is a real war. Nick Fury could only pray silently in his heart. But at this moment, Nick Fury seemed to see Hill hesitating and stopping. There seems to be something I want to tell myself. What else? Nick Fury asked. There was a trace of struggle on Hill's face. She didn't know if she should tell the director these things at this time. But Sharon is not only his colleague, the relationship between the two is also the best in SHIELD. She didn't want her friend to be like this. However, in such an emergency, it seems a bit out of date to say these things. If you have something to say quickly, don't hesitate. Nick Fury urged again. He felt that Hill seemed a little weird today. Hearing the director's urging, Hill finally made up his mind and said, The director, I think I'd better call Sharon back, she's too big and small to use in that grocery store. Nick Fury was taken aback for a moment. It turned out that Hill was talking about Sharon's problem. In fact, Nick Fury doesn't want Sharon to be Lin Yu's assistant either. But, I am afraid it will be a little difficult to get people back. Counselor Lin is very strong, and being an assistant to him is not an overkill, Nick Fury comforted. But, Hill looked anxious. But, Sharon is almost becoming a housewife now, and he has to help Consultant Lin cook there. Hill smiled bitterly and told what he saw. What? Cooking? Nick Fury was stunned. One of the most elite agents of his own, is actually used for cooking. This meow is really overkill. And, Hill agent is even a little hard to tell. Moreover, Sharon already lives with Consultant Lin now. After saying this, Hill suddenly seemed to lose his strength. She really didn't understand, she had only been an assistant for a few days, how could she sleep with Consultant Lin? What? They all slept together. Nick Fury was completely stunned. Almost everyone in the control room could hear this voice. Even Dr. Banner and Tony, who were discussing how to find Tesseract, turned their heads and looked at Nick Fury. Nick Fury hurriedly covered his mouth. Who slept with whom? Tony asked casually, not too much of a problem. Nick Fury's face suddenly pulled down. My old face, SHIELD's face, are all lost. In his heart, there seemed to be 10,000 grass and mud horses galloping past. Why did I agree to let Sharon be his assistant in the first place? It's good now. I'm afraid that Sharon is completely lost now. At the moment, in the grocery store, Lin Yu sneezed suddenly. He muttered to himself, who is talking about himself? I sneezed all morning. It didn't take long before Lin Yu's voice fell. Sharon handed a glass of boiling water to Lin Yu's eyes. She looked at Lin Yu, and she seemed to have some different feelings faintly. She has become like this since Lin Yu took her hand that time. I don't know if it is the influence of the system, or I really like Lin Yu. But, to say that sleeping together is indeed a bit misunderstanding. Although Sharon lives here now, she sleeps in the same room with Wanda. It was also because the two women lived together that there seemed to be strangely no hostility between them. It seems that the relationship has become intimate. It's as if the two reached a consensus. Lin Yu had no knowledge of this. He still regards Wanda as his sister and Sharon as his assistant. Life can be considered at ease. At the moment, in an underground secret base, Loki is taking Hawkeye and Dr. Eric, who are under his control, and is studying the next action. After being controlled by the psychic scepter, Eric and Barton seem to have completely changed. Their thinking has completely changed. And at the moment, Dr. Eric is studying how to build a large portal through Tesseract. Hawkeye Barton is discussing with Loki how to deal with Avengers. As an old agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. and an established member of Avengers, Barton is very familiar with everything about S.H.I.E.L.D. For those Avengers members, they are also very familiar. It's very simple to make them overwhelmed. It is enough to irritate the big guy. Barton's eyes glowed with blue light, and the corners of his mouth smiled softly. As long as Dr. Banner becomes the Hulk, he cannot completely control himself. By the time, it is estimated that the entire S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier will be destroyed by him. Hearing Barton's words, a weird smile appeared on Loki's face. Speaking of irritating others, I am best at it. Talk about the other members, how are they? Loki asked. Although he doesn't care too much about the strength of these Earthlings, this operation must ensure success. He must know all the information of his enemy. And Barton is very familiar with them. A captain of the United States, Steve, had been injected with serum. He was the only successful person in the United States military's super soldier program more than 70 years ago. A playboy, rich second generation, with steel battle suit technology, able to use all kinds of thermal weapons, is not difficult to deal with. Then Dr. Bruce Banner, his body mutated after being irradiated with gamma rays. When he is angry, he will turn into a green monster. He is very strong, but his mind is simple. It is no problem if he doesn't fight him on the side. Natasha Romanoff, a super agent. There is also a consultant named Lin Yu, who seems to be an ordinary person. Ordinary people, Loki asked suspiciously. Among these freaks, there is still an ordinary person. Barton nodded, and then said, "This is the only member I haven't seen. It's very mysterious, but I have read his information. He was originally just an ordinary person. However, there are always strange things around him, such as his pet dog and his car." Before Barton finished the introduction, he was interrupted by Loki's wave. "An ordinary person, it doesn't matter. The strongest is the strongest person, and those who rely on external forces are rubbish. Then focus on dealing with that big guy." In Loki's heart, he had gradually thought of a perfect plan. That night, Loki swaggered into the public eye. And what is even more strange is that he was easily caught by Stark and Steve. Although Thor's appearance in the middle caused some changes. But in the end Loki was captured on the space carrier of S.H.I.E.L.D. In addition, he was put in a prison, specially prepared for Dr. Banner. S.H.I.E.L.D. It was strange that everyone at S.H.I.E.L.D. felt that Loki was caught so easily, but they didn't take it too seriously. After all, people have caught it. The Avengers at the moment have not guessed what Loki's plan is. And when Lin Yu learned the news that Loki was caught, it was already the next morning. Looking at the picture being broadcast in the news, Lin Yu finally showed the long-awaited smile on his face. The personnel have been gathered, and it seems it's time for him to play. If you are right, after this trip, your system should be able to advance to level 4. Lin Yu and the two girls made a move to Roar, and got into the car with Erha. This time, Lin Yu is not going to take Sharon. After all, on that space carrier, it doesn't seem to be very peaceful. 23. After such a long time together, Lin Yu had already regarded Sharon as his own. Coupled with the blessing of the system, Sharon has long since run away. Lin Yu still cares very much about her own people, so she naturally won't let her take risks anymore. Definitely, If it wasn't for upgrading the system, and Lin Yu's character, he would never go to such a dangerous place. But this time, Lin Yu has a reason to go in person. For this trip, Lin Yu is also very well prepared. The two strongest combat powers around him, Bumblebee and Erha, Lin Yu are all with him. But, Lin Yu did not call the phone number left by the Hill agent. Instead, prepare and drive straight up. After getting in the car, Lin Yu took a trip to his seat and directly ordered the Hornet, find out if there is a space carrier in the sky, and then think of a way to get on it. In the past few days after these two Camaros became Autobots, Lin Yu has learned about many of its functions. As the only shapeshifting King Kong in the world, the strength and level of technology of the Hornet are much stronger than the Autobots in previous movies. First of all, the Hornet has Autobot-assisted flight technology. Secondly, the Bumblebee can easily invade most of the electronic devices on the Earth. In other words, what Bumblebee wants to know is nothing on Earth that can hide him. Although the space carrier of S.H.I.E.L.D. has a powerful stealth ability. However, it could not withstand the detection of the Hornet at all. Less than a minute, the Hornet has already locked the position of the S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier in the sky. Immediately afterwards, the Hornet made a magnificent drift, swiftly galloping towards the position of the space carrier. After a few minutes, just below the S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier, the Hornet directly hit a small red sports car on the side of the road. Then, in full view, the red sports car instantly began to break down into countless parts. It was like the pickup truck when Obadiah was killed that day. However, something different this time is that the Hornet did not transform. The sports car was turned into countless parts and directly covered on the body of the Hornet. 10 seconds later, two miniature red wings appeared on the body of the Hornet. And behind and under its body, there are also six huge amounts of jetting devices. Subsequently, Lin Yu gave an order. The Bumblebee rose to the sky in an instant. On the streets of New York, countless pedestrians have seen this magical scene. A yellow Camaro directly swallowed another sports car on the side of the road, and then turned into a car that can fly. This scene is just like in a science fiction movie. The car really flies to the sky. Moreover, it is extremely fast. Subsequently, people suddenly remembered, isn't this car the Camaro who turned into an Autobot that day? After recalling the scene that day, people's mood gradually calmed down a lot. You can transform into an Autobot, and it's not that strange to become a speeding car. After a few minutes, in the main control room of the S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier, an alarm sounded suddenly. An agent sitting in front of a computer hurriedly reported to Nick Fury, Chief, an unknown flight object suddenly took off from the ground and is quickly approaching the mothership. Nick Fury's face changed. At this time, could someone come and prepare to save Loki? Nick Fury's face turned cold. Without playing any tricks roar, he approached S.H.I.E.L.D.'s space carrier directly. This behavior can almost be regarded as a declaration of war. And, if it is a force on Earth, even Qi Zhang's military, when approaching the S.H.I.E.L.D. space carrier, they must call roar. Knock it down for me. Nick Fury said coldly, this space carrier is the most valuable asset of S.H.I.E.L.D. Moreover, there are thousands of S.H.I.E.L.D. elite agents on the space carrier. No accidents are allowed. This space carrier, which is piloted and operated by an agent completely trained by S.H.I.E.L.D., can execute commands extremely fast. In less than 3 seconds, the weapon system had locked the target. Director, the target has been locked, please order weather to fire. The S.H.I.E.L.D. agent sitting on the console solemnly reported. The mood of this agent is a little bit excited. If it does fire, this will be the first attack since the launch of this space carrier. This is a great honor. The honor enough to write into your resume. One of the agent's hands has opened the cover that protects the red button. His hand trembled slightly. Just press the red button and the weapon system will be activated. No matter what it is that dared to approach this space carrier, it will be instantly smashed into a sieve. At the moment, in the main control room of the space carrier, the Avengers members, and even Thor, all looked at Nick Fury. They are also quietly waiting for Director Fury's order. Fire! Nick Fury gave the order to attack without hesitation. At this moment, his figure looked extremely domineering. No matter who is here, you can't provoke the majesty of S.H.I.E.L.D. Nick Fury gave an order. The agent also instantly pressed the red button. In the entire general control room, everyone was holding their breath. waiting for the result of the attack. 1 second. 2 seconds. 3 seconds. The agent sitting in front of the console suddenly stared at the monitor in front of him. Above, a few big characters suddenly appeared. Weapon system failed. What's going on? How can the weapon system fail? Several agents hurriedly checked on the console in front of them. It shouldn't be. This space carrier has been tested many times before being used. This includes several weapon system tests. The test is always good. Why did it suddenly fail after flying to the sky? At the moment, not only the agent saw that row of characters. Nick Fury and a group of Avengers members have seen them all. Tony, who knows human weapons best, hurriedly gave a best solution. If it fails, restart it soon. Hear Tony's words. The people in the entire control room all turned their heads to look at the largest weapons manufacturer in all of America. Yes, why didn't we expect it? If it fails, restarting is the best way. Nick Fury hurriedly ordered, then restart quickly. The agent in front hurriedly pressed the restart button in a panic. But, what surprised him was, after restarting, nothing happens. What's the situation? The agent pressed the restart button again. Still nothing happens. The suggestion of this military industry tycoon is not easy to use. The agent turned his head with horror on his face and looked at SHIELD director Nick Fury. And at the moment, on another computer screen, on the radar showing the location of the target, it has been shown that the target is very close to the space carrier. At this time, the space carrier seemed to be stripped of something. There was no resistance at all ability. If the other party really wants to be unfavorable to SHIELD, then the people on this space carrier are in danger. At the moment, the height of the space carrier flight has reached an altitude of nearly 9 kilometers. It is very difficult for ordinary humans to suck roar in this environment. Let alone want to organize an effective counterattack. It is estimated that these elite agents just walked onto the deck and died in a hurry. At this moment, the only ones who can help everyone through the storm are Tony Stark and Thor. One of them has a steel battle suit that can help flight and roar suck. One is originally a god, and it can live a long time without roar. Like Nick Fury's idea, all the agents in the master control room looked at Tony and Thor. They, as if they haven't acted, have become the saviors of the people on this space carrier. Thor's reaction was a little slower. But Tony had already turned around and headed to his locker room. On this space carrier, it has been equipped with a room dedicated to storing his steel battle suit. As he walked, a smile appeared at the corner of Tony's mouth. This is the time Tony enjoys the most when everyone pays attention to it and is hoped by people. Let me save you. Tony's mood started to get excited. However, just then, most people's eyes were on Tony's upright posture. The agent sitting in front of the console suddenly surprised roar and said, "Director, look." Nick Fury hurriedly turned his head and looked at the front screen. At the moment, on the display, a row of small prints suddenly appeared. "Don't be nervous, I'm already on the deck." "What?" Nick Fury was surprised, hastily looked out the window. At the same time, in the main control room, all the screens showed that row of small characters. All the agents also hurriedly looked at the deck outside the window. Finally, after a few seconds, a yellow figure suddenly passed through the clouds from below and appeared in people's field of vision. It was a small yellow sports car, and its model and brand could be easily seen from the front of the car. Chevrolet, Camaro. But, the rear of this small sports car is completely different from ordinary cars. There are two small red wings on both sides of its body. What's even more exaggerated is that at the rear and underneath of its car, there are several huge amounts of ejectors which are spraying dazzling flames. It is precisely because of these jets that the car flew directly onto the space carrier. But, after seeing this small sports car, the tension in everyone's heart suddenly calmed down a lot. At least it should not be the enemy. Almost all SHIELD employees know this yellow Camaro. Because, a few days ago, the whole SHIELD was busy trying to distinguish the relationship between the captain of the United States and this car. Just because the captain of the United States was accidentally taken a pos-like photo. So, this car, in the entire SHIELD, can be said to be very well known. As for the senior SHIELD such as Nick Fury and Phil Coulson, it is clearer who owns this car. Stark, shouted weakly. Tony Stark didn't even turn his head back, still keeping his head upright, and said proudly, "Don't worry, I am here." Nick Fury smiled bitterly and said, "You don't have to go." Tony Stark was taken aback for a moment, then he paused and turned his head suspiciously. Outside the window of the main control room of the space carrier, the door of the yellow Camaro slowly opened. A slightly thin figure, holding a fat husky, appeared in Tony's line of sight. The entire control room suddenly quieted strangely. The needle falls can be heard. An agent sitting in front of the computer suddenly asked the colleague beside him weakly, "How high are we now?" The colleague next to him also replied weakly, "Almost 9 kilometers. Then, is there oxygen outside now?" At the same time, he shook his head with an emotional expression on his face. "It is clear, even if there is a little oxygen outside, it is scary and scary. It is impossible for human beings to survive outside without the help of other equipment." But, the human in front of him seemed to be okay, holding his pet dog for a walk on the deck. What is going on in this world? Is this person a human? Why can his car fly? Why can he smoke roar at an altitude of 9 kilometers? On the deck, Lin Yu didn't actually want to pretend. He simply didn't understand the relationship between the height of the space carrier and the degree of oxygen scarcity. "In fact, I didn't know that there was no oxygen outside." But, when Lin Yu walked out of the car door, there was a system prompt in his mind in an instant. "Ding, the air around you seems to feel the feeling of being needed by others, actively increasing the oxygen content in the air, suitable for roar inhalation, fresh and tangy. Ding, your pet dog suddenly feels that roar can't breathe well. Awakening has a super survival system that can survive in the void for more than 10 days without relying on foreign objects. The thin, Wang Nuo's oxygen is naturally not a problem." Lin Yu just froze for a moment, and felt that the air around him was extremely comfortable. Can't help taking a deep breath. Then, Lin Yu was fascinated by the scenery in front of him. Standing on the deck of the space carrier, looking around, emptying thousands of miles, it is as free as a bird. Except that the wind is a bit strong, everything else is pretty good. After a casual stroll, Lin Yu finally started to walk towards the main control room on the space carrier. And at the moment, in the general control room, all the people, their eyes widened, their mouths widened, and speechless. How does this guy feel like he's here to travel? At this moment, from the communicator in front of Nick Fury, the voice of the guard at the gate underneath suddenly came. The voice seemed a little surprised. It seemed like something incredible happened. "Chief, someone is knocking on the door outside, do you need to open the door?" Hearing these words, Nick Fury suddenly showed a wry smile on his face. Nothing normal has ever happened to this guy. "Drive to the sky, take the pet dog on the space mothership, and enjoy the scenery at an altitude of 9 kilometers. What's more weird is that he actually knocked on the door. Nick Fury heard for the first time that it takes a knock on the door to enter the space carrier. "Can't you talk about it when you come? Even if it is troublesome to call, send a message." Nick Fury smiled bitterly. Under the gaze of dozens of people, he slowly picked up the communicator in front of him. "Cough, open the door." This sentence seemed to exhaust all of Nick Fury's physical strength. When he comes into contact with Lin Yu, he always feels caught off guard. Every time Lin Yu's behavior makes his brain hurt. But, sometimes Nick Fury also thinks that he is very smart, but fortunately he took the initiative to agree to the request of the other party. With a Sharon, in exchange for the opponent's team, it seems that he has made a lot of money. If Lin Yu becomes his own enemy, it might be even more troublesome. It's so difficult to be a teammate. If you become an enemy, Nick Fury can't imagine the terrifying picture. 1 minute later, Lin Yu's dangling figure, holding Erha, finally appeared in the main control room of the space mothership. In fact, Lin Yu's image, apart from a little thinner, has no other place to stretch too much. But, compared with the house full of agents, and the sturdy guys like Steve and Thor, it seemed a little out of place. It seems that Lin Yu and them are not the same kind of people at all. But, although Lin Yu did not look like a fighter at all the agents present did not despise Lin Yu at all. Even, they feel that Lin Yu is really awesome compared to these guys who look extremely mighty. After all, Lin Yu didn't use any oxygen equipment just now, and was wandering around 9 kilometers in the sky. He is a real master. And Lin Yu is much more approachable than these guys with high self-esteem. As soon as he entered the door, Lin Yu kindly attacked Roar. Ah, is this the legendary Thor? Thor, hello, hello. Mr. Stark, long time no see, your press conference is really wonderful. Hi, Dr. Banner, did you finally run out of Rose's cage? Miss Romanov, meet again. The quality of the fans in our shop is good, right? Almost all the Avengers members in this room had an intersection with Lin Yu once, CDAH. Except Thor. Thor, the last time I came to the Earth was a bit early, and I didn't meet Lin Yu and didn't know Lin Yu very well. Others knew some information about Lin Yu more or less. After all, for a while, Erha, who was making troubles throughout New York, followed Lin Yu. Lin Yu didn't even leash the dog. As soon as I entered the house, I untied the dog leash and threw it away. When Gang Oh got out of the car, he was holding on to the leash, just because Lin Yu was afraid of being blown away by the wind. At the moment, after Erha got out of Lin Yu's control, he sprang up everywhere in the room. It seems that I have arrived in a brand new environment, and I am a little excited. This frightened the agents who knew the true strength of Erha. The existence of Erha is not secret inside SHIELD. Therefore, almost all agents know that Erha can transform into that kind of terrifying monster. For a time, in the entire control room, the agents did not even dare to gasp. And at the moment, in Lin Yu's mind, the system prompt sounded already. Ding, congratulations to the host for meeting Thor. Thor, the core Marvel protagonist for the first time, and rewarding 2 plot points. Ding, congratulations to the host for the first time seeing Dr. Bruce Banner, the core protagonist of Marvel, and rewards 2 plot points. Ding, congratulations to the host for participating in the general Marvel plot. Avengers gathered for the first time and rewarded 2 plot points. In an instant, Lin Yu got 6 plot points. After attending the Iron Man debut conference before, Lin Yu's plot point has reached 14 points. Plus the current 6 points. It has already reached the standard of system upgrade. At the moment, in Lin Yu's mind, the system prompts again. Ding, congratulations, the host has met the system upgrade conditions, and the system is being upgraded. The system upgrade is complete, please check it by the host. Lin Yu was so excited. The 4-level system has long been awaited. At this moment, after hearing the system prompt, Lin Yu simply found a seat and sat down in the main control room. You are busy with yours, leave me alone, I will rest for a while. After Lin Yu said something, he leaned directly on the backrest and closed his eyes. Close your eyes and rest your mind. It's as casual as if you were in your own home. Around, there was a shock. This gangster really came here on vacation. After watching the scenery, you must rest. Sure enough, it was completely different from these mortals. Among the Avengers, Tony was the least convinced. He was originally a character who was not afraid of anything. And every time Lin Yu had an intersection with him, he would be very unfriendly to him. That night, Lin Yu completely robbed himself of the limelight with his Autobot and made himself embarrassed at the press conference. This time, I originally wanted to save the agent of the ship SHIELD, but I didn't want it and almost got tricked by Lin Yu. When we met just now, he even dared to mention the press conference to himself. It's so deceiving. At this moment, seeing Lin Yu so ignorant of everyone, he closed his eyes and calmed his mind. Tony quit immediately. He is going to compete with Lin Yu and grab his limelight. But, just 2 steps towards Lin Yu, he was stopped by Nick Fury. At the moment, the cold sweat on Nick Fury's face has come out. He saw Tony's thoughts at a glance. If these 2 guys fight on the space carrier, the consequences will be disastrous. Not to mention the destruction of the space carrier, Tony definitely can't eat it. Nick Fury knows Lin Yu's character very well. General Ross is a stark example. After provoking Lin Yu directly sent Erha to destroy the entire New York military base. Moreover, Nick Fury heard that General Rose now looks almost like himself. All my hair and eyebrows are burnt away, and my face is also burnt. Terrible, Tony is one of the core members of Avengers, which he formed. It is an essential member. Because, in many technological equipment, SHIELD still needs to rely on Tony. Let's go to the laboratory first and see how to find the location of Tesseract. Nick Fury hurriedly winked at Natasha Romanoff. Natasha Romanoff hurriedly said. Yes, the most important thing for us now is to find Tesseract first. Natasha Romanoff took two steps forward, left and right with Nick Fury, and took Tony out of the main control room. The others also slowly followed. In the main control room of the space carrier, only Lin Yu, who closed his eyes and rested, and Erha, who was scheming everywhere, were left with a room of agents who were frightened. And at the moment, although Lin Yu closed his eyes, but he didn't really rest. After there was no interruption from others, Lin Yu excitedly opened the system panel. A blue light curtain appeared in Lin Yu's sight again. This look, Lin Yu's eyebrows were suddenly overjoyed. I hope everyone will support it and subscribe more.